Or rather, it's about to start booming. And you know if you get on the ground floor, you'll be able to make some serious cash flow. In addition, it's a lot of people down here are in serious need of assistance. And whether you're looking for fame or money or just to redeem yourself for some past crime, you know that this was definitely a great place to Griffiths to do that. So a rock gnome by the name of, let me just find his name here. By the name of Miglin. He guides you for several weeks going straight down into the earth, until going through hidden passages and things of that nature, until eventually you got to some larger opening passages and these gigantic staircases, which lead upwards. What do you do?
Are we there yet?
Almost, says Miglin. As he points this way.
Okay.
You can take your characters and bring them along. As you approach, you start to feel like eyes are watching you. So you look up and see these tiny bowmen, or a tiny bowman, kind of watching over your entrance to the area. You see him hail him in rock gnome language.
Oh, come on, get it over with.
Eventually, gets to the top. You guys get to the top here, and you can see there's been some sort of kerfuffle, and you see these massive iron gates, and what appear to be a lot of noise coming from back here, like a chick 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 chick.
Is that the battle going on? Like, what sounds are those?
What was the sound of that? That was this machine here.
Uh-huh.
It is most likely being used to bring something up.
Does the disturbance to the side of the gate look like anything that might spill out into the rest of the area?
What do you mean?
Like the overturned cart or whatever the hell's going on, is it under control, or does it look like it's something that might get
it definitely seems under control, although they seem to be having trouble with getting the cart to stand right up. They seem to have overpacked it, and during a sharp turn accidentally overturned it.
I'll nudge Zanward over here. So, aye. Why don't you go help him and get some coin for the work?
Loving the accent.
And I'm just sitting here going, yeah, you know, all these people, they're just so short. I probably should go over here and help anyways. So I'm going to come over here, and I assume it's just going to be a strength check.
Yeah, give me a basic strength check. It's pretty small, I mean, compared to you anyways. But that definitely seems big compared to them, like they overpacked it.
I think I got
nice.
It.
with one hand and just using your body weight, you easily overturn this thing with all of its package, with all its packings inside, as well as a couple of rock gnomes who accidentally were still in there at the time. You manage to bring it right up, and all these guys become very grateful for your assistance.
Were any of the contents damaged or scattered?
You could see there's a single barrel kind of rolls out as he... as he lifted it up. It would be about going this way, almost hitting the stairs. It's rolling that way.
And if you don't stop it, it's going to go down the stairs, and it's going to become the new slinky.
It's going to make noise, and that'll attract the trolls.
Those trolls and stuff.
Maybe. You don't know.
Hmm. Well, we'll try to stop it without actually getting in front of it.
Cool. You just kind of put your foot down and you stop this tiny barrel.
Any indication of the contents based on the sound of it stopping?
Liquid. Most certainly liquid.
Beer.
If you can give me a check with advantage to tell if it's ale. Although, if it's not ale, then you're not really going to help. It's definitely not ale. You know the sound of ale, and that ain't ale.
It's safe from the dwarf.
It's quite dark right now, just due to being miles and miles underground. Who here has some sort of light?
I have a spell.
Cool. I'm just gonna put a little marker right there, saying that you're. What do you make turn a light on your body?
I am going with one of the javelins that's on my back.
Cool. Okay. Yep. So these guys, thank you very much. Yeah. And Migvin kind of asks you to hurry, as there's things to be done.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah, you approach these massive iron gates. As Brunor and Doran just kind of sit on top of one another. Eventually he kind of taps two times on it, and they start to open up just these massive gates. And eventually you look inside, you can clearly see it's some sort of labyrinth.
Oh, yay. Yeah. I always do great with labyrinths.
He tells you to follow him closely, and do not get swayed by anything you see in there. It is trapped heavily. So you guys enter in. It looks like Doran and Brunar. You look out and you actually see some gold, or it looks more like a golden chest, kind of off in the distance. Yeah, within the cave. Scared. Within the labyrinth.
Our view is obscured at the moment.
Yeah, I'm aware. It's
okay.
Because you're being led through, so you don't actually have to do it.
Okay.
But, so he didn't want to make the entire labyrinth.
No, the labyrinth does exist. It's just making you guys go through it means I can't make other people go through it without a guide later.
It's all good.
Boom. Eventually, he leads you through. At a certain point, you actually heard noises. It sounded like a minotaur or some sort of bull creature. He leads you on this way.
Wait, did someone forget to feed the dog?
I take a zip from my AL and start humming. My button song.
Did you start humming?
Where did he go?
That's very haunting.
You hear the German music.
Eventually you guys reach the town itself. You see people working busily, trying to restore this broken town. Water leaks from this building, from this ruined area. The man kind of tries to take a drink from it. People trying to winch up some supplies.
Any kind of indication of a marketplace or social gathering?
Social gathering. You do see a sign that says there's a tavern this way.
Oh, finally, we're here. Let's get to an inn and get some drinks and some rest.
Yeah. Migvin says that's a good idea. It'll be, you guys can go down that way. I'm gonna head over to the trader's market.
Now, this whole time, do I have to, like, duck or like dodge stalactites? Like, how tall is the ceiling?
The ceiling is, well, you can see right here how far it goes up.
Okay.
So it goes up really high. So you do not, you definitely do not. And if you did before, you don't now. It goes up tremendously high.
Now, when I walk into the tavern.
We walk to the tavern, you might need to get concerned.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Wow, instantly. That's hilarious. It's at this point when, out of sheer luck, you guys hear a ruckus coming from over here. You hear it, words shout out. What languages do you guys know?
Draconic. Something that's not going to be useful here.
Probably not, no.
Just common and halfling. Sadly, no wizards with insane intelligence here.
No. How about you there, Brunar? Just more. I'm asking what language do you know?
Yeah, Dwarven is common.
Just Dwarven, okay. That's when you start seeing orcs jump on the barricades and start attacking.
And I thought this wasn't gonna be fun.
you can roll me initiative if you'd like to get in.
Well, they'll go in first.
Zanward and Bruno got 7. What'd you get there, Zanward?
I got a 14.
Oh, nice. Not bad. Not 16, but still not bad. So you see these guys start attacking. This one up top instantly cuts this one in half. And same with the one up here. And you see this one kind of move in. And so does this one. Whoa. So does this one. Zanward.
All right, so first thing I want to try to do is save that halfling. I can move 25, but I'm going to assume the water is going to be difficult terrain. So it's going to be a 1, 2, 3, 4. As I pass him, I'm probably going to push him into the water just for fun.
as you go through, you notice it's actually quite, it's not deep at all.
Oh, so it's not difficult terrain?
No, it's not difficult terrain. You notice that quickly.
1, 2... 3, 4. It's still not quite close enough, but that's what the javelins are for.
Exactly.
So I'm going to take one of the javelins that is not lit up, and I'm going to chuck it at the first guy.
Cool. This guy appears definitely more armored than the rest.
Well, it doesn't matter. I think I missed.
Hilarious. You throw a little too long, and you see your javelin. See your javelin actually land into the stone beside it.
Alright.
Doran, the little halfling that could.
When Zanward ran through the puddle there, would I have noticed how far up his ankles or shins did the water come?
Definitely. You notice that for him, it would definitely not be difficult terrain, but because you're so short, it would be for you.
Alrighty.
That's what you get for picking a halfling.
I know. Oh, trust me, I'm going to pay for it later based on everything I've heard.
Ow, ow, ow.
Movement is a challenge. I like challenges. Am I in range for darts?
For darts, definitely. I think you were in range for darts where you were. Wait, you mean throwing darts?
Yes.
Oh, I'm pretty sure it's 25 feet. Yep, perfect.
Alrighty.
And because these guys are so much bigger than them, you have no chance of hitting. Assuming you don't aim for the leg. You can only throw one dart at a time in this game.
That's fine.
Yeah. So 18 and 18 for 12 damage. Sweet. Wait, a 12 damage dart. Oh, because you have sneak attack.
Hold on, that's not calculated right.
Yeah, that does seem high.
4 plus 6 plus 3. Copy and paste error. 1 second. I'll correct that. There's 6 too many on that.
Hmm.
Should just be 1d4 plus 3. So just 6 total.
6 total, cool.
Does a full round action, if I was standing still, would I have thrown two, or is it always
No, no, it's you need a feet to be able to throw two at a time.
All right, so it's always just...
Yeah, because a bow in this universe does like 1d6 damage, and so being able to throw two weapons would be greater than a bow. So they thought you need a feat to be able to do something like that. Which makes sense balance-wise. Brunar, although Zanward kind of missed, Doran's doing some good damage to the heavy right here. What are you doing?
I remember reading about the movement is a hustle. Is that a feat, or can I increase my movement speed and charge to that?
Wait, let's see, 25 feet she brought there. They can you can charge 10 feet at any time, which allows you to do your action, but then you have to stop your turn. So you could potentially get to here, which is 25 feet, and then charge to here. Him. Yeah.
Yes.
So you do that?
Yes.
Cool. And you give him a good swing with your axe, I assume? 13. Unfortunately, he blocks you with his shield. Yeah. At this point, these guys are going to just go. Oh, no. These guys are very unsuccessful in their attacks. Although they start shooting, some of them think they need to disengage, which they do. Others kind of try to get in a better position before they attack. And this guy over here misses horribly.
Whoops! Don't pay attention to that.
Yeah, don't breath weapon this guy. He's gonna get burned.
No, I'm just looking at it and it was...
Cool. This guy here is going to try to attack Brunar. Ooh, 16. That is going to hit you.
Barely.
Yeah, so he takes his machete. It's going to deal 7 points of damage. And this guy over here is going to attack that little guy. And he's going to slaughter him instantly. Zanward.
Well, since they're all dead, I am going to go here. And since Brainer is off to my side, I will use my breath weapon.
Cool.
So they need to make a dexterity save.
Cool. Unfortunately, they are rather dexterous. What's your DC gonna be?
Hold on, let me pull it back up. It's, 14?
14? That seems a little high. But, sure. One of them misses. This guy over here, he ducks right away, but the guy behind him gets splashed completely. How much damage?
Let's see. That is 2d6.
Cool, give me a roll. That was sad.
And it's acid damage, if that
yeah.
means anything.
Oh yeah, it means his clothes are all burning off. Gonna be naked pretty soon. Doran.
Okay, this guy's approaching, right?
Yeah, this guy's attacking this guy over here. But he launched his sword into the ground when trying to attack.
Alright, so move up and take a swing at him.
Cool. You can use two weapons while in melee, and yeah. Is there a reason you have advantage?
I put both rolls in there, so for advantage, disadvantage. So for the
most part, you can
just ignore the second
one. So you got a critical one on your first hit, and then got a 22 on your second.
The halflings do have a lucky thing that lets me reroll crits.
Oh, beautiful. So you got a 14 instead.
Yep.
sweet. So that means, do you still get that +6, or is that wrong?
The +6 on the main hand is correct.
Okay. Seems really high.
Let me verify that. 1d6 plus... No, that is incorrect.
Yeah. I don't know where you got that from. It's okay. It still does a lot of damage. What's that? 5?
Subtract 6 from it.
So that's 5. And then, 6. and then sneak attack damage of 2. Although you don't have sneak attack right now. You need to get on the other side of him.
No, any ally...
adjacent.
Exactly.
Beautiful. Okay, so it looks like you do, what, 13 points of damage?
Yeah, so it's...
You just start ravaging that guy. Brunor.
I'm gonna keep attacking this guy.
Cool. Unfortunately, he bashes, your weapon bashes against his shield once again. It's at this time you see a small woman come out of here. She takes a small potion out of her pouch and she throws it at these guys.
And hopefully she doesn't miss.
Well, it's a saving throw for them. Hoo hoo. Ho 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 ho! They're engulfed. They each take 15 points of damage. After this one dies and this one is aflame, awful. This guy is gonna run away while on fire. And this guy, having seen that, it would be his turn now. He runs for it.
So, I just looked it up, and I just confused Pathfinder with Dungeons & Dragons.
No one's surprised there.
No one's surprised. And Pathfinder is a 10 plus whatever, and in Dungeons & Dragons is 8 plus whatever.
Yeah,
so
that's why I knew 14 was way too high.
Too high.
Yeah, I was like, 14 at level... I have level 4 players, and they aren't at 14 yet. Yeah, great. This woman kind of gives you a nod as she goes back into this ruined building.
Did that old hag took all my honor from this battle?
I would like to come over here and pick my javelin back up.
Cool. I assume that at the end of every battle, unless you guys are like running away, that you pick up all your items. There's no reason not to think that. You see these guys who are, some of them are horribly wounded, and the others are actually just straight up dead. They start dragging their bodies off.
Well, we're going to take a rest very soon, right? Possibly?
Perhaps. That's right. Asuka, who was it that got brutally hurt last round?
Yeah, Bruno.
Bruno, you got -7, right? Yeah, oof.
Oh, okay. So... I will use Cure Light Wounds, which is 2d8 plus 2, which cool. Might be overkill. Well, yeah.
It does seem like overkill for 2d8 plus 2 for 7 damage.
Yeah, for 7 damage, that's...
Yeah, use it during battle. That's definitely... Yeah, healer.
How does healing surge work in...
Healing surge in this one, basically when you take a rest, you get to spend a hit die plus your constitution modifier. So basically, you guys were going somewhere. If you're just going to sit down and chill for a while, you'll be able to apply bandages and spend one of those. Honestly, 1 to 10 plus 3, you'll probably be back at full.
Now, first things first, and proceeds to rifle through the pockets of the corpses.
Cool. These guys refuse to let you rifle through the pockets of the guards, but of the one man here, you can most likely easily do it. Give me a search check, which is based off intelligence. If only you didn't get a 6 on your search. You start rifling through, you find some coins, you find a couple of silver coins, about 3. In addition, you find what he has on him, which is a large shield, a machete, and some fine leather armor.
Is the leather armor better than just standard? Better than studded?
No, and it's also too big for you.
Okay.
Like, by a couple of sizes.
It'll fetch a shiny coin, I bite.
Yeah, most likely.
I can carry that.
Okay, so Brudarp starts putting machetes and weapons and shields and armor into his backpack. Until eventually this guy just has nothing but bones left. And then he uses the bones to pick your teeth. What do you guys do?
So I don't know.
Dane?
What was that, buddy?
Dane, I'll need some rest and ale.
The tavern. Yeah.
A pint of ale the size of my head sounds really good right now.
Yeah, you see these guys start muttering as they drag their friends off. Damn orc raids happen every second day. They start going off. Oh, really?
Let's go, let's go.
Actually, as we're passing the halfling that was pushed into the water, if he's still in the water, I'd gonna help him out.
you see him trying to you see him trying to squeeze the water out of his clothes. Just as he looks to Zanwar, he just kind of shakes his head.
On the way passing, I am gonna ask him. It's like, does this really happen every 2 days?
He nods and says, yeah, these orcs showed up about a month ago, and they just haven't stopped attacking.
Well, you should get some of the big folks to do something about that.
He says, what big folks? This is all we got is those two.
Was everyone in this group halfling? In this area?
Everyone here is a gnome.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. That's why that's so small.
I did not catch that part.
Look how small there.
I saw the bigger guys up on top.
They're big because they're so high up.
Gotcha.
It's perspective illusion.
Well, best of luck. Bye.
Thanks.
It's like, sucks to be you. Bye.
Essentially.
You know the tavern.
Some of you guys remember the
somewhere to the east, right? Where'd our guide go?
He went up north.
He said this way, but
don't get lost in the city. You might get mugged.
Or mug.
Yeah. You guys start going through, and although it seems a little tight for you, you see every now and then a little gnome passes by you, and up. Go looking upward, it goes just meters and meters upwards, but it is quite tight when it comes to horizontal. You got two there, Dory. Congratulations.
East we go.
You know you didn't. Oh, never mind. Okay. Just flipping a coin to figure out where we're going.
Basically.
Yeah, I smell for ale.
Give me a check with advantage. Perception check with advantage.
That's wisdom, right?
Yep, wisdom. I gave you two in that. You're welcome.
Give me a sec. Manual rolling.
And one more roll for advantage. Advantage means you roll twice, by the way.
Ah, so it was 1d20 plus my wisdom. And
yes.
Advantage is one more roll.
Yep.
In the chat window, you can just hit the enter key again, it'll re-roll it.
Is that so?
Yeah, but I used the plus four, so...
Cool. That's definitely good enough. You see, it seems as if Brenner starts to float a bit as he starts following his nostrils towards ale. It's leading him this way.
Come on, guys, it's definitely this way.
Oh, I know that. Look, there's ale down that way.
You guys start to hear the sound of fresh water and talking. You begin to see an outdoor courtyard, people talking, drinking, eating, having fun, merry. As you look over here, you can see a large statue spewing out fresh water into the grotto. A couple of guards just hanging off duty. A couple of unguarded gates. Statue in the distance. And of course these passageways that are overhead. About 15 feet high. So with a good jump, you could probably reach them.
Unless you're 3 foot tall.
True. And of course you do see a guy over here selling ale.
Are there any groups that look particularly deep in their cups?
None that you see, though.
Scant opportunities tonight.
I immediately take a sit. What? There are no waitresses here?
You notice that these tables are not designed for the size that you are. So as you kind of sit down in this tiny child's chair, and then start complaining about waiters. Go on.
I'm going to move over to the other side, and since Brainerd's going to have issues with the chair, I'm just going to sit on the floor.
Cool. very similar to Japanese tea drinking, it's about up to your waist, the table.
Okay.
I hope they have mugs to our size. Damn it.
Oh, no one's got mugs dwarf size unless they're actual dwarves.
After a few moments, this man kind of looks at you. What do you do? And Dorne,
is he just leering? Or
no, he's,
is just
he's looking at you, like his face goes turns to your direction. In case you want to flag him down.
Guard, what is he wearing?
Oh, he doesn't look like a guard. He looks like a normal guy.
Oh.
He's wearing what everyone else seems to be wearing. As Doran speedily runs through and goes over this bucket of water.
Well, the
fresh water for the drinking the ale tender. Sweet.
We've been traveling down into this underground area for a while. I'm sure our supplies and water skins are low.
Yep. Your good friend Miglin would have given you water on the journey.
All right. So having refilled their water skin, we'll go chat with the barkeep.
Cool. He says greetings.
Hi. How you doing?
Quite well.
So some nasty problem with the orcs here, eh?
He laughs and says, "You betcha. They've been on their butt for a long time now." The borough warden has had it up to here, and he kind of points to his neck with them.
Well, Leslie, he hasn't had it up to here, and make like a cutting gesture at my neck.
He laughs. Oh.
You know, do you think the borough warden might be willing to hire some folks to maybe deal with the problem for him?
He kind of turns his head and says, "Probably." Especially he kind of looks over to these two, especially giants like them.
Well, maybe there's some opportunity there, if you know what I mean.
He says, "Most definitely."
So where do we find this warden, eh?
He points, he says it's just in the district up above here.
In this time, Bruenor is losing his patience and starts...
Beautiful.
What the fuck is my ale?
Doran's interrupted as this guy says, "Excuse me, I have to go serve some people." He kind of turns and starts walking away with a couple of ales. And he gets over to here, and he kind of puts two down. Yeah, he puts two ales down. They appear to be kind of... They're big for them, but they're medium for you, the size of the cups.
What the fuck is this shit?
It's ale. Take it or leave it.
Don't you have a bucket? That would be appropriate size for a dwarf.
He sighs and he says, I can tap a keg for you if you like.
Nah, we're busy.
His face kind of goes sour as he returns.
And I'm tasting his ale. Apparently, it couldn't be good enough for me.
Oh yeah, it would definitely be good enough. Especially having you know, run low on your supplies.
As the barkeep returns, Doran will make use of Thieves' Cant to ask if there are any other opportunities in this area.
This guy quickly gets confused as you talk about your jargon. He says, I don't know what an apple and pears are, as you would most likely have said something like that in your way.
Please tell me you don't play Guild Wars 2.
Oh god, I fucking hate that game.
Okay, thank you, because there's so many references to spies and apples, it's sad.
No, that's all coincidence.
Well, never mind. If you knew what I meant, if you experienced it, you'd know what I meant. I'll take a pint of ale, though.
So, sure, no problem. And he kind of gives you a pint.
I'll slip in one of the silvers from the orc. Probably still stained with something.
He grabs onto it, and he pocks it.
Don't pay attention
Gives
to that.
Gives you a nod.
So, when Doran rejoins us, that was a perception roll. And I come back to something like, what was this thing about the pears and crap?
Some of you know what I mean. Some of you will never know what I mean.
I see what you mean.
Doran sits down in a chair that's appropriately sized for him as he looks over the Zanward on his kind of going Indian style, and Brunar sitting in a tiny chair. So you guys sit there and drink. You kind of rest for an hour.
Bruno, you want me to find you some tea and a cozy?
Love that accent.
You'll notice it probably changes without me realizing it like 15 times tonight.
Regardless, I love it.
Yeah, I've tried doing accents before and they always change, so I just don't do them.
The tears don't give me a problem. It's the small size of these cups, damn it. Yeah.
You want to do a rest for an hour? Hang out for an hour?
I don't have to sleep like in second edition, right?
We can sit Yeah, you just basically sit there for an hour and everyone kind of... You drink and you rest and you wound up your bandages. So what you do is roll 1d10 plus your constitution modifier, which is 3, and you'll gain that much health. Eleven. Beautiful. So you're back at 13. Cool. So you guys sit there for an hour. Eventually... let me just think for a while. Eventually you see one of these kind of guys kind of stand up, and they just kind of pass by. And as they do, Doran actually notices kind of a message from the Thieves' Cant. To basically follow.
Just quietly nod, make a gesture with my hand that I understand.
Cool.
So guys, I'll be right back. I just gotta use the little halflings room.
We're in a gnomish city. There are no little halflings room. There are little gold gnome rooms.
I'll just drink your drink.
Cool. eventually get to there and you don't notice anyone.
Are there any markings or nooks in the walls? Anything that might someone might leave a message or note
none,
or something?
None that you see, no.
I'll just continue on a little further in case he's just ahead of me.
Cool. When you get about here, you hear this door behind you kind of open up as he comes out.
Oh, there's
out.
Doors.
Oh, yeah. What do they look like? Supports?
Kind of under.
No, they look like doors. I figured that out.
Okay, good. I figured they look like supports for a second there. He kind of comes out and says, psst. And he begins talking thieves can't to you. I heard you talking before. You part of one of the guilds?
Well, let's just say that I tend to freelance. But I don't want to step on any toes, you know?
He nods. He says, you know, there's some good profit to be made around here. There's a supply caravan that's supposed to be going out. And some of the guys around here are real desperate for supplies from one of the places. And if you accept it, because they need outsiders to do it, then maybe we can actually get make some more profit from it. I mean, the town might suffer, but we'll make money.
I don't know. No, we're just new in town. I don't want to cause too many waves, you know?
He kind of puts his hands up and says, okay, if you're not looking to make money, then I guess we're done here. And you see him kind of close the door, or go to close the door. And the door is closed.
Oh well.
Okay, you guys get back to each other, and you see Brunar is still drinking. He's in a drinking contest with himself.
So you're holding the cup like between his fingers, or what?
It's a normal size. It would be like a pint compared to like a halfling. So for him it's small, but for you guys it's pretty big. He's used to eating drinking buckets.
So while Zov was talking to the keg keeper over there, he mentioned there was some work to be had. You boys perfect. Think you're up to fighting some more orcs?
Perfect. I get bored after I drink.
Sweet.
Where are those orcs?
You know, I didn't necessarily come down here to do nothing. I was assuming there would be work. So let's get to it.
Excellent. And of course, there's, you know, a finder's fee for finding the work and being the contact, you know, I'll take a little extra cut.
I pick love him up guy. From the collar.
He's a little too far away, even for you.
Oh. I'm going to just walk around nonchalantly, and then I want to pick him up by the collar.
Excellent. Unless you want to contest Doran, he kind of picks you up with like a single hand.
Would I have opportunity to see him walking around the table out of
yes.
for
yeah.
no reason?
If you want, you can
to the table.
You can duck behind Brunar, definitely. Using him to kind of keep between you and him.
Easy now. It's all negotiable.
Brunar looks at Dorian and says, here's your bonus, and burps.
We'll see how negotiable it ends. I don't take well to being manipulated.
What? You get to bash orcs' heads in? You still get paid? It's a win-win.
I go to pay.
Cool.
I get them to it.
Yeah, he asked you for some silver.
Yeah, I probably should go over and pay for mine as well.
Basically, just holds his hands out, and you guys put a few silver coins in his hands. And he pockets them all.
So, where is the orcs?
Well, we got
right.
We got to talk to the warden first to get hired. You know, make sure that everything's copacetic as far as our deal goes before we agree to do anything. That's just good business.
They're actually gonna pay us for killing orcs? Oh, lovely.
Indeed.
And I would proceed to lead our hopefully only slightly inebriated friends towards the Warren's office, wherever.
Yeah, that how much alcohol would you say you've consumed, Brunar?
Just one cup.
Brunar, I mean? Zanvar only drinks one?
Two cups, the proper amount for a door for an hour.
Okay, cool. They consider your constitution boosted by one score. I'm just gonna roll 2d20. Oof. But you're a little inebriated. This stuff's a little stronger than you thought it was. Although you would have advantage. Yeah, you're fine, never mind. Dang, dwarves. They're drinking. But yeah, you have extra constitution now. It's a bit of a home rule.
Mm-hmm.
So what way are you guys going?
So where is that warden?
So yeah, the barkeep directed us towards the north, I think you said?
If that's where you guys heard.
Ah, crap.
Yep, that's my DMing style. Whatever you guys want to do.
So yeah, we'll walk up this way and ask a friendly, well, maybe not friendly, but
a guard
who is proximate to us.
Cool. You see one right there, and they seem to be guarding some sort of large tunnel leading down. You can hear training going on in the north, as well as some people just kind of passing by and conversing.
How deep does that tunnel seem to go?
It goes into the darkness further than you can see. Although you have dark vision, it still goes pretty far down.
I just waved to one of the guards. Oi! Where do we find this Warren character?
They kind of raise an eyebrow, and one of them points a spear up to here.
And just wave jauntily and carry on.
Thank you!
Sorry, no. Okay, you find this tiny little ladder leading upwards.
Dorn definitely scampers up that first.
Yep, you get up there easily. Bloop.
I'm gonna follow.
Cool. Takes you a little while, it's a little bit big. And eventually, Brunar, I'm assuming you try to.
Yes.
Cool. And eventually you get up there, and you see these two doors in front of you. They're a little low, Zanwar's gonna need a duck. Okay, what do you have to do?
So is this where the warden is? Inside here? Warden?
Sorry, I didn't actually hear you. What'd you say?
Did the guard say it was here?
He did indeed.
And proceed to knock on the door.
You hear eventually somebody opens the door. See, it's a little guard. I kind of asked, what would you require?
Well, we're here to see the Warren about some orc problems he's having.
You see him nod. You see him nod as he opens up the door.
All right.
You can see this area is it's filled with supplies and statues and weapons and food. You see three guards conversing right here, as well as the one that opened the door returns to it. And across the way, at a tiny desk, you see, it looks like a soldier that doesn't look like the rest. It's wearing a tiny makeshift crown.
A makeshift crown? That's interesting.
Would any of the contents of this room happen to be unattended and useful in a utility sense?
You definitely see guards are looking in all directions, but But you can most likely pocket maybe some knives or some food. Or if you're really good, you might be able to open up a crate and see what's inside.
Yeah, well,
you gotta be really good.
Yeah.
We'll play.
Yeah, the place is well ornated, as well as there's tapestries on the walls. And of course that large symbol underneath you.
Just take a mental note for later.
Bruenor whispers to Dorin, "You seem to be good with words. You arrange us a good deal. I kill the orcs."
Right. Well, I'll work out a good deal, all right. So I'll just call out to the middle of the room. Hi! Who wants the orcs dead?
I see this guy kind of look up from his papers, and he kind of raises his spear and kind of tells you to come over.
Just wave over to the to Zonward and tell him to crawl on through.
Yeah, and I proceed to try to get around. It's not going to be an easy task.
Basically, you just your back's bent and you're hunched over.
I probably knock something over with my tail if.
That wouldn't be surprising. Eventually, you get up to this man. He's a tiny little guy wearing a little makeshift crown. It says, "Who are you?"
Jaunty bow. It's like, "I'm Doan, adventure expertise, and my two companions here, the Zanwad, the dwarf. Excuse me, Zanwad. The obviously, you can see he's the dragon king. He's our muscle,
clearly."
And we have, of course, our Bruna. Bruna, you're a cleric, right?
No, I'm the cleric.
The dragonborn's the cleric.
The dragonborn's a cleric.
Okay, no. So I got that backwards.
He says, "Greetings. I am the Borough Warden here, Cargian Disengulf. You said you wanted to kill some orcs?"
Indeed we do. Assuming the price is right.
He kind of looks at you and he says, "I'm not sure if three people, even of your size, would be able to take the orcs. There's much more of them than you. When you'd be outnumbered 10-1.
Well, numbers don't matter if they don't see you coming, you know?
Not sure if that's true if after the first 5 minutes of battle and they're still 5-1 on you.
Well, builders just over there could tell you how good we are in a fight. We took out a recent raid just now. It didn't even break a sweat."
he kind of laughs and says, "What, two, three orcs attacked?"
"That was before breakfast."
Says, "Well,
yeah,
do you think you could take 10 at a time?"
"It would be challenging, but I like a good challenge."
He kind of looks at you guys and he says, "Well, if you're in for a challenge, you could do something for me.
Something valuable to you, I hope."
He nods. He kind of takes his crown off and he kind of plays with it a little bit. He says, "There's a large keep, just northwest of here. It used to be the center of our leadership. Unfortunately, it's been locked down for hundreds of years. We tried to get in there earlier. We tried mining through the top. And once we did, all our men stopped coming back from there. And then some of them started coming back, but they came back wrong."
How wrong do you mean?
"I mean, like, they started drinking blood and trying to kill everybody they saw."
"Well, that would be wrong."
So, yeah, he nods. "Wrong. But unfortunately, what's down there is something important to me." He says, "It's my ancestor's crown."
"So this marvelous piece of shinery ain't your normal crown?"
He gives that a chuckle and says, No, this is something I made myself."
"I never would have noticed."
He kind of gives you a mean look.
All right. Well, obviously this crown of yours is very important to you. The real question, I suppose, is just how important is it?"
Says, well, how much are your services?
Excuse me one moment while I confer with my compatriots.
Please. As you guys kind of move backwards a little bit. Zanwar's starting to get a cramp.
I would think a dragon would be used to be sitting in a cave surrounded by loot and stuff.
It's not sitting in a cave, it's having your neck kind of twisted downwards like that. You have to use one of your javelins for balance at this point.
Oh. Yeah, I probably shouldn't take those off.
So, fellas, how much do you think we can get out of them for this?
That depends on how dangerous it is. We're talking at least mentally changing. There's probably some sort of dark magic. And thank God you guys managed to bring someone along that actually knows crap about that. Maybe.
But don't they die by axes?
You should have the religion skill, so yeah, you would know stuff about that.
Okay.
Yeah, you're good.
Hopefully.
Yes, I am a priest. I should hopefully have the religion skill.
You'd be surprised. I've met
people it could have been magic or something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
I mean, you know.
There's a lot of magic clerics in my universe.
So I'm thinking, 1,000 gold between the three of us, and first claim to any magic we find. He sees this guy's ancestral crown of leadership, after all. Could be worth a kingdom to him. Or do you think we could get more for it?
Out of character, I don't know how.
That's kind of where I'm at too. I have no idea what's reasonable to ask at this point.
A 1,000 silver might be reasonable, but 1,000 gold's a lot.
All right. Yeah, we are level 1 after all.
Yeah.
All right. So 1,000 silver is what, 100 gold?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. So 100 gold. First claimed any magical items that we encounter we recover the crown.
We don't have to mention that we came across anything magical. We just had to bring him his crown back.
This is true. Alright, so returning.
Cool.
So, me and my colleagues here have discussed it, and we think that it would be entirely reasonable and fair on our part to only ask you for a small sum. We'll say 100 gold pieces and supplies for the trip.
You see his eyes kind of turn wide. He says, 100 gold pieces? That's a tremendous fortune you're asking for.
Well, this is your ancestral crown. It's worth a kingdom, don't you think?
You see him kind of get angry, and then he sighs and says, very well. Get to it. He kind of points northward. Points in this direction. He says, it's down there. Go this direction and they will tell you where. And he says, I don't want a dent in that crown.
So, good, good. Pulls out a sheaf of paper. Writes down the agreement. If
awesome.
You'd be so kind as to sign here, and we'll be on our way.
You see him read it thoroughly a couple times, just to make sure he didn't screw him over anywhere in the writing. And then finally he signs it.
Most excellent. We'll be back before you know it.
Love that accent. Okay. He gives you a nod as he puts the crown back on his head.
So he agreed to the supplies for the journey part, yes?
Supplies for the journey?
100 gold and supplies.
And supplies.
100 gold
and supplies. And supplies for the journey.
That's what we said.
Oh, okay. I guess he did.
That is what he said.
I guess he did.
All right.
He, and by he, I mean I, wasn't paying attention.
Take a look around, boys. Pick up whatever you think you'll need.
I come over here and I take just the right amount of food. I don't want to take too much.
Cool, cool. You take a bag of baguettes.
Okay.
I would like to make a point of looking for any potions of healing that might be around.
You see none.
My priority would be the kegs. Maybe they have ale in it?
You see one keg of ale.
Okay, I feel my two flasks.
It is not tapped yet.
Ah.
The gnome-sized keg or keg-sized keg?
Gnome-sized keg. So it's carryable in one, with one arm.
Alright. That's...
Would I carry this? No, I don't think so.
You can carry it, yeah, with one hand.
Hey, Dorin, is this in the agreement?
I don't know. Is it a supplies?
Yes, of course. I'm a dwarf after all. I need fuel.
Well, necessities of life are what they are. But let's not take too much. We don't want to overstep our welcome.
Is cool. It far? I mean, he gave you directions. How long did...
It would take like 5 minutes together.
Ah.
Let's see. Now, as far as actual items, does everyone have light sources, rope, containers, grappling hook, crowbar?
You only need one of those.
True.
I have not a grappling hook. Does anyone else have? I have a crowbar.
Doran's a pack rat, so he's everything I'm rattling, I do have one of at least. And oddly enough, it doesn't exceed my weight somehow. I actually had to add that up. Are there any arms and armaments that stand out?
Yes, but they're all halfling sized.
Oh.
Let's see.
It's not to wish I had made a halfling.
Well, you are in the Gnome City.
Are there any leather armors better than studded? Like dragon skin or anything like that?
No. Hey, you can see most of these guys are quite undersquared.
I resent that.
Just have to check. You know, you never know where opportunities arrive.
Yeah, you look around, you can see these guys are quite undersupplied.
Okay. So this is really just foodstuffs, then?
Yeah, foodstuffs, swords, and whatever the crates contain.
Alright, so I already have rations for 5 days. I want to double up on that, if that's available.
Yeah, sure. The rations won't be dried rations, meaning they'll go rotten eventually.
Yeah, sorry, we'll eat those first.
Exactly.
But I'd already gotten the baguettes, so maybe we'll save the baguettes for later.
True. He's got a bag of baguettes.
Alright. And probably just a large sack to carry any loot that we find.
Cool. You just grab a sack and get on your way.
Yep.
Excellent. You see this guy kind of give you an evil eye as you shut the door behind you.
The moment I get outside, I stretch.
Yeah. Give me a balance check to stretch and not fall off and horribly die. No.
Okay.
You and Zanward are close enough that you can just jump down and not even be affected as Doran kind of goes down by his hands and feet with the ladder.
Maybe before we go, maybe we should try and find somewhere to ditch these things I grabbed from the orc.
Oh yeah, supply store to sell that stuff off. Yeah, so are these like workers and stuff in red?
The guys in red are citizens.
Citizens, alright. So just go up and ask the closest one to me. Hey, excuse me, sir. Is there a merchant or a general store hereabouts?
They kind of look at you and say, you haven't been here long, have you?
Nope.
Says, sorry, no, we're pretty undersupplied. If you go, most of the weapons and things like that are being bought by the guys up here.
Excellent. Thanks very much.
Was it this way he pointed?
Yeah.
So
you get to there and you see a bunch of people training. Well, I'm just gonna put that back.
Well, now here's the question: is how much is orc-sized weapons and armor actually going to be to these people? I mean, you can salvage them.
Yeah, you can see most of them are using spears and shields made of splintered wood. You can see a large line actually forming of people who can't actually get spears. Like, there's not enough, so they have to share.
Wow, that sucks.
They are quite undersupplied.
Yeah, you take a regular sword and you can break that down into at least a dozen spear tips.
You guys say that to somebody?
Well, mention it very loudly to my companions.
Yeah.
Like a stage whisper.
As one of them passes you, that they kind of say, well, that depends on us having a forge now, doesn't it? Would help if the district wasn't shut down.
Well, it's neither here nor there. Is anyone actually interested in some of this fine equipment?
I wish I had picked a different type of dragon. I could have made a forge.
Just because you can spit fire doesn't mean you can heat metal that hot. You see a couple of these guys kind of start bidding for it.
Get the one silver, two silver. Do I have three? Four.
The highest guy goes up to 15. Or goes up to 13.
Sold to the young gentleman with the hat.
He takes your sword and starts swinging it around. He runs off as he throws 13 silver into your hands.
And that gets pocketed right away.
Is he like off balance when he starts to swing that sword?
It's so off balanced. It's like a great sword to him. This machete.
Let's see. We also have the large shield, which could probably double as someone's house roof.
If they didn't already live in stone houses, that would be true.
Just to save time to forego the pleasantries, how much can we sell the rest for?
The rest really aren't useful because they aren't ready to use. They'll have to be deconstructed.
So, large shield and...
Seven silver.
Alright, that gets pocketed.
Cool.
You're paying for the ale the next time we're in the tavern.
Paying? You've got a keg under your arm, buddy. Who needs to pay?
Okay, what do you guys do?
How much are healing potions? 50 bucks?
50 gold, so that's 500 silver.
Yeah, okay, never mind.
That, of course, assumes that there is a magic shop nearby that sells them.
Yeah, no, I realize I'm not going to find any here. I'm just trying to...
Well, maybe. There was a person who kind of came out of a store, threw down a fire potion, and then went back in.
This is true. But I probably would not have remembered that just now. So, true.
With your accent, coming from New York, terrible.
Indeed. All right, lads, shall we be off?
And off we go.
All right.
This is gonna come to a sad, sad ending if the rogue leads the way.
Oh, I have a feeling it will.
Where was it? North? Hop, 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 hop.
I think it was, he said off to the west, dude. Just got a very general... He gave us fine directions, though, right? Northwest?
Yeah, sure. I eventually get up to where you are, and you can see a green glow coming from this area.
You boys, wait here a second, yeah?
Thorn will proceed to stealthily proceed forward to scout out the area.
Cool. You start scouting out the area, and you can see the following. You see Miglin, your guide. He's sitting in this garden of glowing mushroom caps.
And what's to the northeast?
It looks like a large construction site.
Okay. And more gnomes. Okay. Alright, so I'll step out of the shadows, wave to Brunner and Zanwar to to come on and follow up. And greet our former guide warmly.
Cool. He gives you a nod and says, greetings.
So we're off to fight the orcs. Think you can direct us?
The orcs. The orcs live northwest of here. There's probably about 30 of them, as far as we know.
Where are we going to go for the keep, Dorin?
Yes, this is true, and I'm forgetful on a late day Friday. So, instead of the orcs. So, where's this keep that we hear tell of?
He says if you just go past this here barricade, you'll be able to, and then just go west. Wait, no. Yeah, west. You should find a small hole in a ladder leading down. And, of course, just a ruined area. That should lead to the keep. And he says, why would you want to go down there, though?
Profit.
What did the warden trick you into going down there?
What do you mean, trick?
It's incredibly dangerous.
Yeah, that's why I got these two guys.
He sighs and says, very well, it's your funeral.
Oh, well, much obliged for the directions.
He gives you a nod.
You can find the map for that place, or someone that knows his way around.
As for guide, he can probably, he says, just return to me and I'll be able to tell you wherever you need to go. He gives you good directions, though. He tells you to go this way and then just keep going that way and you'll find it. A prophet, and a dwarf.
A prophet, and a moppet.
Get to there. This guy kind of tries to stop you and asks you, what are you guys doing?
I'll just show him a copy of the contract from the warden. It's like, we're on official warden business.
He kind of scratches his head and says, okay, just watch out for the orcs.
Well, they'll watch out for us, I assure you.
I can assume, like, I can just, like, step over this and I've been...
Yeah. It's pretty poor quality. It's made from old construction wood and things like that. Scamper.
This way!
Yeah, hold your horses. Now let's do this thing like professionals. It's like his voice cracks because that accent hurts. I shall proceed. Yeah, I'll proceed to scout out ahead stealthily.
Cool. Give me a stealth check. Dex plus one, if you have the skill. 15. Plus 9. That ain't right.
Well, it's expertise.
Oh, you got expertise? Yeah. Man, you got expertise at level 1? That's ridiculous. Cool, yeah, plus 9. Rogues. Cool. So you stealth up to which direction do you go? This way or this way? Cool.
You need another bracket on that sleight of hand.
Oh, thank you.
Now you get up there and start looking around. Immediately, you find an orc just covered in blood. Kind of just aimlessly rifling through rocks.
Do I see any others?
You do see one more in the distance over here, but it's too dark for you to see anything else.
Okay.
The way our guide told us, I whispered to Zonward.
Yeah. And you do notice, though, a hole.
Right. Okay. Being thorough, I will go back down the other way and see what I find down this way.
You look this way and you see about this.
Okay.
There's nothing south? Well, I guess...
None that you can see. It's too dark for him.
Okay. In my professional estimation, gentlemen, how quiet do I think you are?
We're both wearing heavy armor.
Right. Okay, so you're not.
I mean, maybe.
Alright, so the easternmost orc here is kind of just poking around the rubble.
Yeah, he's kind of aimlessly as he's covered in blood. He sees, he doesn't really appear to be looking for anything in particular, he's just doing stuff.
Do I have line of sight on him?
You... mostly.
Alright, so first things first, I'll duck back here, whisper quietly. Wait, there's two I can't see the other orc, right?
You know he's there. You heard him. But you can't see him.
Oi, there's two orcs. There's one real close and there's one far away. I can hear him, but I can't see him. How you boys want to do this? Now, I can sneak up on one of them, but I don't know if he's going to have any friends.
Because it'd be easy for him just to kill the one dwarf that, or the one, yeah, kill the dwarf, no, kill the one orc that's rev, that'd be probably easy. I don't know if there's anyone else, but the moment he mentions two orcs, I want to take the light off.
Cool. Now you can dim it if you'd like.
Let's just take it off right cool. now.
You take it off. Which of course means
complete darkness.
Not for me.
Yeah, I'll remind you guys that halflings do not have night vision.
Yeah, I don't think dragons do either.
Hold on, I did not think about that. Let's look.
That's why I said you could do it.
Okay.
So here, to distract them, and we could pass unnoticed to the hall. Although I would hate that idea. Less orcs.
I'm just kind of looking at you. It's like, sneak by them? You?
A completely reasonable idea by a dwarf. Let's not fight.
I have two weaklings with me, don't I?
Yep.
Weakling? I'll show you a weakling. You wait here.
And I just give him a stern look, even though I can't really see him.
I will proceed to... I saw the layout previously, right?
Yeah, well, you saw enough, but you'd still have a lot of trouble. You couldn't see much.
As Doran steps away, I will be listening in for the first sign of battle. If something goes wrong.
Is D&D next every other diagonals...
No, and it's every diagonal is.
Yeah, it's just okay. Pathfinder.
Is it just Pathfinder? I thought it was D&D 3.5.
Well, I don't know about 3.5, but it should be just Pathfinder.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of that rule anyway. I prefer hexagons, actually.
I remember reading that diagonal is half the distance.
No, not in this one. It's if you could do this, then it'll be fine.
Alright, so basically I'm going to try to sneak up on this dude.
Cool.
Taking my time to be quiet.
Cool. And trying to see.
Right.
Give me a stealth check. Cool. You got 50. Man, you are too stealthy. Okay, yep, you get up to basically wherever you want.
The rubble in front of me, is it actually solid or like all shifty?
You can't tell.
I mean, it's like, is it sand? Is it solid?
Oh, it's definitely rock. It's definitely rock. Rock and dirt.
Can I take a very hard look at it to see if it
You have, like it would be have to take more of a feel at this point.
Okay.
It would be very difficult to... you see it. You kind of feel it. Some you kind of grab two handfuls. One's like a big rock, and the other one's just soft dirt.
Okay, so I'm gonna stay off of that.
and trying to stick to whatever shadows there are. I'm going to try to get a line of sight on this guy.
It's pitch black, so.
Okay.
So everything's a shadow.
Yeah, it's nothing but shadow.
Is this a standable space?
Yes.
All right. Is he within melee range?
He is, yes.
So,
out of the shadows.
Okay. So you try to thwomp him. And, yeah, what weapons are you using?
Short swords.
Cool. Short swords. Yeah, you can use two short swords. I was thinking, for some reason I thought it was a dagger. You take your two short swords, and do you say anything as you kill people?
Silence. Silent and deadly.
You say silent and deadly, or you are silent and deadly?
No, I think he is.
I am being silent and deadly.
Cool. So you take these two, and you simultaneously put them both right into his heart. And you see blood splatter at the other side.
How can you see blood splatter off the other side? It's pitch black.
Okay, never mind.
Feel it splattering over my
feels
face.
It splatters all over him. And that's when you see him kind of... That's when you feel him kind of draw his face towards you, and you start to feel him growl. Or hear him growl.
Gotcha!
He's gonna try to bite your face. 15
roll
hit. Definitely roll initiative, but he is going to bite your face because he's so close. Does a 16 hit your AC?
16 does hit my AC.
Okay, cool. Does 3 points of damage as he bites your face.
That's unfortunate.
It feels loud.
Did he make any noise?
Yeah, he's going grawr. It doesn't appear to be orcish.
Doesn't appear to be orcish.
Does not.
Do I recognize it?
No, you do not recognize it.
The 0.3, in case anyone's wondering, is what I use to break ties.
Roger. I usually just let players go first, so.
Well, I mean, between, let's say, me and Bruner both rolled a 7.
Well, in that case, it doesn't really matter. Because you're both allies. Same team.
Yeah, anyway. I play with some very competitive people, apparently.
Yeah. Yeah, we roll by the rule of cool in this game.
There you go. Is this guy still alive?
Yeah, he's still alive, and he's biting at you.
Oh, that's unfortunate. I thought I got his heart.
Okay, Zanwar, Doran, and Brunard, your roll?
Yeah, I already changed mine. It cool. was a 14 last time.
Okay, cool. And Brunard, you too?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So they get to go first, man. You start hearing some roars coming from this direction. And although you can't see very well, so I'm just gonna boop, boop. You are attacked several times.
Oh crap.
Fuck.
Yeah,
stick to the ranged attacks.
this is a bad spot to be at. So you're gonna get attacked. Wait, that's +4 is a little high. But either way, 16's gonna hit you. He's going to slice at you with a machete.
Don't you hate that?
Oh, 7 points of damage. As you are chopped down, and you start screaming in pain.
Oh, okay.
Encounter's
over. Let's go home.
I'm going to roll 1d20 to see how hurt you are. Okay. Your wound is mostly aesthetic, but it hurt a lot, causing you to go unconscious. Man, you're lucky.
Should we try to break your legs?
No. If you got like a 6, I'd be like, I have to break something that you don't use a lot, so I'd probably hurt your head. But you got 1, which is aesthetic wound. Zenward.
I'm gonna
That's all home rule, by the way.
I'm gonna have to light back one of because I heard the roar, so I'm gonna have to light a. One of my javelins again.
Cool.
Which that takes my standard action.
So I would assume that you only dimmed it, which is why I said you can just dim it. So you basically just snap your fingers, it goes back to full.
Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay.
Yeah. So I guess give me a quick religion check.
Quick religion check. So that's a. Roll d20 plus. Did I have it as a 4 or a 3? A 2.
Nice. Yeah, you can tell right away that these guys are in fact undead.
They are undead.
Yeah.
I'm gonna fuck them up the ass.
You can try.
I am going to use, unless this is a touch thingy. Well, actually, I probably should save it.
There's no touch in this game, anyway.
You can always heal the halfling.
Screw the halfling.
Just saying.
You know what, since Doran would get a chance right after me, I am going to use Cure Light Wounds, which was a 2d8, I think we discussed, plus cool. 2. So I gave him 9 health.
Okay.
Do you heal from negatives? Or?
Nope. So you do not heal from negatives in my games.
Okay, so...
Brings about the
fall. How about something else?
So although you are awake, you are still prone.
Okay. Oh, he's still prone? Okay.
Yeah, because he's on the ground. He fell.
And I suppose that's the end of my turn.
Sounds about right. Doran.
Get up.
Can I move through them?
You want to what?
Can I move through them? And start to...
Oh, it's Doran's turn, not Bruno's turn. But yeah, you can easily move through them.
You can move through an ally's space.
Exactly, yeah.
Movement turns needed to stand and move here and attack.
I'll allow it.
Right. So, actually, getting behind Zanward and hiding. That's a halfling thing. I can.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. Cover. Cool. Cool. Sounds good. Give me a roll.
Which yeah, cool. Sense. I was distracted.
Yeah, 12's not terrible. And these guys aren't exactly that wise. Being zombies. Brunor.
Yes, I will be charging this guy.
Beautiful.
I'll show you how it's done.
And using your axe or greatsword? Or?
My great axe.
Great axe. Beautiful. Just give me a roll. 15. Yep, that hits. Okay, you chop one of his arms right off. However, with his one good arm, he's going to try to chop at you, Bernard. He gets a 20.
I think that hits.
Yeah. Unfortunately, only barely gets past your armor, dealing 2 points of damage. The other one sees you, and he's going to straight up tackle you. He's going to try a grapple check. So this is going to be a contact between you and him.
That's strength, right?
Strength or dexterity. I suggest strength.
Thanks.
Cool. So, you put out your great axe to try to stop him, and he basically grabs onto it and you, and is now kind of roughing you up. So you are now grabbing, you are now in a grab with this guy here. And you guys hear sounds coming from down here.
That's great.
Let me light that up.
I don't see it that far down.
You do. Teammates don't. And they're the ones you have to worry about. But, there.
And we're the ones that have to worry about it.
Yeah. Cool. And, Zanward.
Alright, so if I try to attack that orc,
You have to get a critical one to hit Bruner.
Okay. Well, that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to get out my...
Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, I was going to say you can't get through there, but you can.
Hammer,
yeah.
And my shield.
Beautiful. That would take all your turn to get that out.
Really?
A shield takes a full action to get out.
Okay, then right now I'm just going to get out the Warhammer.
Beautiful.
Okay.
Cool. And so you're smashing this guy here?
Yes.
Cool. You basically smash his head like a pumpkin. It just explodes everywhere. You kind of get like a sigh of relief until you see that doesn't seem to have stopped it. But the guy on top of Brunar's now has no head. Doran.
Hold on.
Since my cover walked away.
Yeah.
I will just walk up and stabity stab.
Cool. Yep, stab the guy attached to Bruner. He would technically be a different space, but dang. Okay. Okay, so you give him two more stabs, and they just basically go in and out of him. Very similar, Zanward.
Okay. That would explain why it's like, eh.
Why Doran's not doing any damage.
No, why I didn't do any damage.
Oh, no, you did damage. You exploded his head. But that won't necessarily kill him.
Didn't really seem to do, yeah, didn't. Really.
Yeah, well, it means he has no head.
And he cannot bite me.
Yep, but he could still rend and tear. So Doran, yeah, you stab a bunch of times, but the guy's just not, he's not affected by it, it seems. He just goes in and out. Brunar.
What sort of magic is this? As I attack the guy I was attacking?
He's currently he's too close for you to use your axe.
Ah, I need to break the grapple, I guess, then.
Essentially. Or you can take out your hand axe and start slicing.
I can do that. So this is how the range work. If he's next to me, I cannot use the big weapon.
Yeah. If he's next to you, if he's currently grabbing on you, because he's too close for the swing.
Yeah, only light weapons can attack while grappled.
Yeah. Which is a good. I don't think it's a rule in D&D Next, but it's a rule I like, so I maintain it.
So. Let me do the attack roll. Which fails.
It's not a critical failure, so that's good. But yeah, you basically try to whack him in the head. You try to whack him in the head, you kind of slice into his spine as you go into his the stub where that his neck is. So yeah. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so somebody's going to slash at you there, Jenner, with one hand. But he's going to miss. One's going to slash at Doran. The 15. With his two-handed thing, he does 7 points of damage.
Jesus.
And the one guy's going to try to rip at Drano with his hands. He's going to do two attacks. I'm assuming both those miss?
Yes, give me a sec.
Your AC's 15. One of them hits.
Ah.
So he does 1 point of damage to you. I'll adjust that. Zenward, back to you.
Alright, so they are zombies.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to drop the hammer, because that's not going to do that much damage, because that's bludgeoning. I'm going to be kind of ironic, pick up the javelin that has light on it, because I should still have another action, I'm going to try to stab Bruno, or the guy that's got Bruno grappled.
And you're hoping light will do something?
No, I'm just being ironic.
Okay, cool. You stab into him. You do manage to hit him. You stab right through. But having done that with your only light, that happens again. Probably shouldn't have done that. Okay, Doran. You notice the light just go to black as you hear Zanwar stab.
Great.
Well, I don't know, because that was with a 4 AC. I think I probably missed.
Oh, no, it doesn't mean it misses. It means that it didn't do anything. And for these guys stabbing in, it means it didn't do anything.
Don't suppose the whole javelin would have been lit up, not just the head?
I think he said just the spearhead.
Yeah, I did say just the spearhead.
Damn it.
Having fun with light.
What are you thinking, Doran?
Darkness. I can hide.
But can you hide against guys who can see in the dark?
Ah, this is true. Disengage is what, half speed?
Yes, and it's your entire action.
Speed for me is 10. Difficult terrain to scamper up on the rocks?
To scamper, that would be a climb check or strength, athletics.
So I'm disengaging from the guy from my bottom right.
Cool.
And climbing up on the rocks.
Sweet. Give me a roll. 15 athletics. Nice. That's definitely enough, so you managed to move with half your speed. Which is... Considering you also add in your movement, you're about...
You're about 15 feet up. 5.
I assume you also use your regular movement too, though. So you're about 15 feet up.
Okay. Oh, that was disengage's full action, so that's it.
Okay, Brunar, who can see perfectly. You're currently wrestling against this guy. What do you want to do?
Yes, so my attacks don't seem to matter?
No, your attack just keeps missing. When you first attacked him, you chopped the guy's arm right off, so you think your attacks are doing well.
Ah, okay. That's what I'm asking.
Yeah.
I'll attack this guy that's grappling me, I guess, again.
Cool.
With the
hand axe.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
so
hand axe.
Yeah, you just start swinging wildly, and by the time you look back, you see this guy's just in pieces. Do you want to move at all?
Oh, shit. I move here. No, if I move, I will provoke an attack of opportunity. And at
this
least here I can protect Dorin from the back guy.
True.
D&D Next doesn't have attacks of opportunity when you're moving within an opponent's threat range. It's just when you move out of his range.
Yeah, yeah. So if you move to here, then yes, you move to here, that would be that guy.
You can circle your enemy all you want.
Well, as I said, if I stay here, you can only be attacked by this guy.
This guy's too high anyway. He's 15 feet up.
Ah, he left?
No, this guy's 15 feet up, so it would be hard to see him. But this guy definitely will attack you.
Yeah, I'm trying to protect the weakling.
These guys are going to double team you. One's going to... They're both going to get advantage because they're on the other side. So one gets a 20, and the other one's going to attack you, getting a 13. I'm assuming that's going to miss. However, it means you were dealt 1d8 plus 8 damage. Ooh.
Bye-bye.
Nope, that puts you to 1 health. Or 2 health.
Oh, shoot. Okay.
As he gets slashed good.
When am I able to use my second wind?
Anytime. As long as it's an action. So on your turn, you can use a second wind.
Okay.
Zenward.
Alright, so... When I stabbed him with the javelin... Is the javelin, like, still in my hands?
Oh, yeah, you definitely would have pulled out by that point.
Okay. Now, I see this other guy down here.
Yep.
And I see that my allies aren't doing well.
You're having trouble finding, Dorin.
And I am kind of... I already used my Cure Light Wounds. So I'm going to reach into my spell book. I am going to do divine. No, that's not it. What, sacred flame?
Cool.
On the guy that we haven't really done any damage to yet.
Guy across from you?
Yes.
Hold cool.
On. My screen just. All right. So that is. So it gets engulfed in flame, so that's a light source.
Yep, you have to attack him, though.
Oh, yes, I do. Hold on. Save. Roll 1d20. Do I add anything to that?
You should add your proficiency.
Okay, so that's wisdom.
Especially since you pulled out your book to do it. Oh, the critical one's not good. Yeah, there's no real bad effects are gonna happen though.
Crap.
So I'll allow it just to skip to next to Doran. Doran, you are 15 feet up.
Okay.
You can finally see again. You see Brunard just got slashed horribly by the zombie.
Alright, let's see. Hiding is still a full action at this level. So it's probably not going to do anything. But I'm gonna throw a dart at the guy to my left.
Cool. Give me a roll. So close to a critical. Yeah, you throw it and it kind of embeds in his head.
At least the sneak attack applies.
No. And Brunar.
Yeah,
You have full access to your axe again.
Oh, okay. And about that second wind, does that work as the book I read, or is it a different house rule because I can read the...
Yeah, it's, you get 1d6 plus 1 HP as an action.
So, that's an action.
It'll be, instead of attacking, you get a gain health. That'll be it.
Nah, that won't be too helpful.
You've got one hit point, dude. Stay alive before you try to kill something.
Well, yeah, but if these guys hit you, they're going to be doing 1d8 or 1d10.
There's no way I can do both.
Move out of range. Well, nah, that.
Then they get free attacks, yeah.
Yeah.
Staying in range. Like this movement, maybe it will attack Zonward.
They would definitely get attacks there.
Yeah, one of them would get an attack opportunity.
I do it the 3.5 way, where if you move out of a square, they get attacked. See that guy? He started trying to keep her lean
portion of the cage. That's what sounds like her. I will just heal them.
Cool. 1d6 plus 1. And now, unfortunately, it's these guys' turn as they start slicing and dicing.
Do they not notice that I'm the one with the light source?
They don't seem to care.
Okay.
They just see fresh dwarf meat and they're going for it. 22 for the fresh dwarf meat. And a 15 for the fresh dwarf meat, both hitting. Doing 10 points of damage total.
Explodes.
Essentially, as they just start chopping at you. I'm gonna roll 1d20 to see if damage. Oh, yeah. They basically embed their sword into your head. As you go down.
The keg!
And the keg also gets split open.
Oh.
Sandward.
Alright, I'm gonna take the javelin that I still have in my hands, because I don't really have. I didn't pick that many offensive spells. I picked a lot more defensive. And, is this going to actually help? No, that's not going to help me at all. Now, I'm going to take the spear or the javelin.
Cool.
And I'm going to chuck it at him.
Awesome.
And we all know what's going to happen. Everything's going to go dark.
You have more than one spear.
I do, but I guess since I'm not moving, I will take another javelin out and I'll chuck it instead.
Cool. It stabs right through him and it gets embedded in him. And now he now has a javelin inside him. Doran!
Do I get an indication that the darts are doing anything even when I'm hitting his vital areas?
You definitely think he should be dead by now. So you think they're doing nothing compared to fighting a living target.
Okay. There's a broken ale cask on the ground, right?
Sure is. All, right where your friend is.
Friend being a term that doesn't necessarily apply to you three.
Apply very well.
I shall pull a torch out.
Sweet.
And
again, I should have picked a fire dragon. No, try it number two. Next time, I'm making a damn fire dragon.
Trying to think if there's anything clever. It's like level one. Like there's nothing. There's nothing to do. Yeah, go out in a blaze of glory. Pull the torch out. Pull the flint steel out. Start striking.
Yeah. You have what's the word? A tinderbox. You can just take that thing out and light a thing and then throw it.
Alright, so
it'd be like lighting a match.
It was a cask of ale, does that spread to the squares around it?
Depending on the quality, it might just explode.
No, I mean like the cask that got split on the ground.
Yeah.
Is the liquid already more than just the one square?
Yeah, it would be I'll say it's everywhere. It's all these squares.
Okay. Oi, Zanwood! Watch out! Throw the torch at the feet.
He says, giving him no possible chance to do anything else.
I don't get a reflex save?
Nah, everyone's gonna get a reflex save.
Oh, okay.
Do you want to roll or anything?
Yeah, everyone roll for the reflex save. Failure.
Even Doran up on the rocks?
No, Doran's fine, but Zanwar does need to make one. And I'm going to roll 1d20 to see what other wound that Briar gets. Oh, lucky him. The burns are mostly a stag, so it's launched this way. And Zanwar, you got a 16? Cool.
Yes.
Okay, I'll probably do about 1d10 damage. Roll it, Doran.
Alright.
Nice.
So
yeah, you see this guy with the arm. He catches fire, is launched back, and he stops moving. Or he starts flailing, rather. Yeah, he starts flailing wildly, not knowing what to do. And, Brunar, roll me 1d20.
What was it?
Roll? Just 1d20. Hope for a critical.
Yeah, sure.
No. You go one more notch towards Death's Door.
I have 40 points from the surge, eh? Don't forget about that.
Yeah. You even had, if you had that, though, they still did a mass amount of damage to you.
That was going to bring you up.
That was right.
Look at, back to, Berserker's turn. Okay, the one Berserker's left, gonna go for Zanmarn.
Alright.
Okay, unfortunately he misses and he embeds his thing into the wall. Zanmarn.
Alright, so I took 9 damage.
Oh wait, Zanmarn, don't you have an ability called, not Raise Dead, but,
I do have one, and I did take it, I should have kept my ward up. It's Spare the Dying.
Spare the Dying, yeah. You touch Brunar and he just gets back up.
But I have to ask a question first. I took 9 damage.
Okay, that was the attack roll, I think.
The 9 damage that I rolled was the damage of the fire.
Okay.
Yeah, you're fine. You take no damage.
Okay. So yeah, I'm going to come over here and I'm going to use Spare the Dying. He's at 1 hit point.
Cool. Meaning that the chance of him getting horribly injured again are high.
And, well, I don't actually have to move to do that.
No.
But I can't do anything.
Nope.
That was the space that Zanmar's standing on fire right now?
It was a fast explosion, and it burned up quickly.
Alright. So I can't do anything, so that was my action.
Doran, can you find anything else to explode?
Jeez. Let's see. I've got so much random things on me, I feel like I should have something. But
he's a MacGyver. Chaotic neutral MacGyver.
Alright, you know what? I'm drinking a potion.
Cool. That's a shame. As you chug this potion while you're attached to the wall. Brunar.
Can I move?
Yep.
My full...
You can kind of backflip up.
Movement and reading and action, right?
Yep.
I will be moving here and reading an action.
Oh, cool. Do you want to try to help your friend?
If he comes, I'm at one hit point. If he comes up here, I want to attack. He can stand it, I guess.
Sure. Sounds good.
At least one turn.
Sounds
so
good.
I can get behind him and attack next turn.
Cool. Berserker's gonna continue attacking Zanlord.
Alright, bring it on. Misses!
Nice. He just kind of slices against your armor and just drags across. Are you using a shield too?
I do not have it equipped.
Oh. Okay, it would be a 16.
I do have one, but I don't have it on right now.
Okay, so it would be a 16 at the moment then.
It is 16.
Zanwar, your turn.
Alright,
it's time to put on the shield.
Yeah, I'm gonna put on the shield.
That'll be a full action.
That's fine.
Cool. You strap your shield to your body. Doran!
Just on the off chance that I manage to hit something critical. Probably miss anyway.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Oh well.
Actually, it lands in him. You stab him right in the head again. But doesn't appear to care.
I have nothing that's not piercing.
Brunar, you're up.
Would the charging from this angle give me an advantage?
No. If you go to there, he'll get an attack of opportunity.
So it's basically here with no advantage, right?
Exactly. Unless you can convince Zanwal to back off somehow. Well, actually, what you didn't know, but you would have been able to do, is use your disengage. You would be able to move to position, then disengage to here, and then you would have been able to move in. So I'm going to say you did that.
Well, I'm new to this.
Yeah, exactly. You're new, and you didn't know how useful disengage was. Disengage allows you to move at half your speed. So you would have been able to get on this other side. So you have advantage now.
Yeah. Let me roll my attack roll.
Luckily you have advantage, so you get to roll again. 14 hits. You 13 damage. Yeah, you split him right down the middle. You see both sides frantically try to continue attacking, but have difficulty.
Oh, this dwarf is crazy. With the long reach of his axe, he chops everything that's moving.
Okay, eventually...
Stay away from the nails and the biting stuff.
Eventually, it's just a puddle on the ground.
Oof. Weaklings.
So, that was fun.
Yeah, it's at this point where Brunar kind of realizes there's still a large piece of metal embedded in his head.
Oh, it's extra armor.
It was bleeding to take it out?
Somebody you want to try ripping it out?
I would prefer to do a short rest and then try to rip it out and then do another short rest. I want to make sure I have. That'd be me just being too. Let's give it a shot. Since I'm right there.
Okay, cool. You want to take out your healing kit and try to utilize that?
Alright.
Do you understand? Do you have the medicine skill?
I do have the medicine skill.
Okay, cool. Then this will be less fun for me.
Roll d20 plus wisdom twice.
Just plus one.
Plus wisdom, plus one.
Oh, that's 8. Seven. Okay. So you kind of start. You kind of start pulling on it, and Bruno's like, "Whoa!" And you just kind of put your foot up against him and rip it out. And you see him kind of fall to the ground, just incredibly dizzy. And you kind of patch up. You kind of look up into his skull, and you see there's like a massive fracture in there. And you just kind of like, let's just ignore it for now.
That ale was strong.
Oh, this is going to be a bad.
Pretty much, yeah. So Doran climbs down. You guys gather your equipment up again.
Yep.
These guys had swords or something on them?
They had machetes.
Gather those up.
Cool. One machete is covered with somebody's blood. Not going to say who. But four.
Yes. So yeah, we should probably go back to town.
Exactly.
Just saying. Rest up a bit. Etc. etc.
Boy, that was pathetic.
We're not usual orcs.
How can I tell you? All I have is piercing.
Yeah. This is where you regret putting that that date or that expiry date on your contract. Really shouldn't have agreed to have it done by a night.
There's no due date.
Oh, there's a due date, baby. No, you're fine.
Yeah. Yeah, so let's get back to town. Rest up naturally.
Okay, you guys want to just take an hour to rest, or?
I think Pruner needs a little more than an hour.
He's had brain surgery.
Yeah. Cool. So yeah, there's a you've heard that there was a doctor in town. It should be just yourself.
I mean, there was some lady with fire bombs. Maybe she has some
healing potions.
Exactly.
And by resting, I can get my spells back, which I went through most of them.
One battle.
Maybe we can find
something
that can help us in this battle. Your weapons were ineffective.
My weapons were fine. They kept turning the light on and off, and on and off, and on and off.
Find myself some things. These machetes, are they medium-sized?
They're medium-sized. For you, it would be like wielding a greatsword.
Okay.
So it would be 1d8 damage, or it would be 1d10 damage for you.
Right. Yeah, so but I would actually
no.
Want to hold on to one of those.
Cool. And they're most certainly slicing.
If I need bludgeoning, I can always hit something over the head with a torch.
Alright, so I've got a question about the one spell I didn't waste on this battle.
And that is?
It says concentration up to 10 minutes. Does that mean I have to use my turn?
No, it means that you can't use another spell that has the concentration ability at the same time. So only one concentration spell. So only one concentration spell per.
Well, it's the only one I have that has that. Okay.
Yeah, so you're fine, yeah. But later on, if you get two, it'll be like, oh man, I have to choose.
Okay.
Between Bless and singing music.
Yeah, that's what it was. And I'm sitting here going, maybe I should have used
Bless would have been so useful.
I'll gather whatever is left. I'll definitely have bills to pay with this injury. No?
Oh yeah. Preparing a cracked skull is going to be a lot of silver.
Yeah.
There goes your share already.
Oh wow.
Okay. So you guys head south, I assume?
Yes.
Back in the city.
Yes.
And you guys know what music this is.
Oh, you're actually playing music?
Yeah, oh, you guys
play music.
Yeah.
The headsets.
Everything sounds like it's from an 8-bit video game. You're not missing
it's, much. Hey, whoa,
no, it's missing
hey.
A lot. I love 8-bit.
I'm trying here.
Yeah, no, my computer, the browser sound doesn't go through the earphones, so it's just playing at computer speakers, and I'm just not hearing it.
That's cool.
It's playing now that I turned it up. But.
Cool. As you enter in, this new district that you haven't seen before, I see some people kind of working, trying to get rubble out of buildings. A couple of scuffles going on, and what appear to be people waiting, bleeding outside of a door.
Hey, yeah. Give me some. Dorian, give me that contract. There was a clause there for something gear we could take.
Supplies?
Yeah. No, that's right. We can help ourselves to any supplies that we need on our journey.
Well, I need definitely healing supplies right now. That could be in the contract, couldn't it?
Most certainly.
Now, what do we actually see about these guys down here?
You can see they're both horribly wounded, but they seem to be unattended.
Right, so if they're horribly wounded and unattended, we're not likely to find healing assistance there.
But they definitely do appear to be waiting outside this door.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So let's mosey on down. Anyone impeding us?
Nope. Just walk right into it.
Yeah, so bold as brass, just walk right in.
Cool. You walk in and see just tons of people on stretchers, bleeding and dying. Wounds similar to yours, except for Brunar's bite.
Oi, medic!
Brunar's been bitten?
Yeah, he got bit.
Sorry, I'm thinking about like all the zombies.
We're gonna have to put you down, Brunar.
Don't remember being bitten.
Yeah, remember that when the guy, No, I'm sorry, it was Doran who got bit.
Yep.
His face got bit.
Yeah, because the guy that was grappling me had his head exploded.
Exactly. You see two gnomes. One woman right here, and another little man. They seem to be working hard on the people who are already here. Trying to sew up wounds. By candlelight.
I'm gonna wave in Zanward to come on in and talk to the healers to see if he can help out in trade for some priority care, VIP treatment. Help out a little as we're getting healed up.
I go and I look and I see that I'm gonna have to duck. It's gonna be so crowded. It's just. But eventually, I just like come in. Yeah. And it's like. I move in front of Doran, and I probably accidentally hit Doran with my tail.
Now, as they see you come in, this woman right here starts yelling at you, barking orders at you. She says, "She says she needs you to go fill up one of the. There's a bunch of buckets by the door, and she says she needs you to go fill them up with water." And to bring him back. Make yourself useful and actually get some stuff done.
I turn around, I look at Doran, I signal him to go ahead and do it as I go forward.
Doran kind of gets really dizzy and he kind of feels like he should sit down.
Okay.
Not Doran, I'm sorry, Brunar.
Yeah, I was gonna say Brunar.
Yeah. Zanboy, what do you do?
I talk to the woman and I say, I've got this bumbling imbecile right here. We've got a serious trauma wound to the head, and we need. Is there any way we can take priority with this since it seems to be a serious issue?
Some blood kind of squirts out onto you, from the guy she's currently working on. And, she says, I'm pretty busy as it is.
Okay, and considering that I actually now have blood on me, it's like, I'm not certain I can push her. Although I might be a dragonborn, I'm not usually very intimidating. So, it's like, I'm gonna just go back. It's like, just wait your turn.
What?
There are people in here that are actually worse off than you. I think that one guy, I think he was missing his entire arm. You still have your entire skull.
Most of it.
What do you mean? My skull is missing? And Bruno's trying to look up, stupidly to look at his skull, realizing that he can't.
You start feeling around up there, and it's just soaking wet with blood. This is adventure's working out great, guys.
I know.
What was this monster's onward? Definitely were not regular orcs.
I got your water.
She says she's appreciative of the water. If you're finding it, getting it to her. She says thank you very much.
Hey, Zanwart. You got any more of that glowy stuff that you use on the dwarf that you can use here?
After a couple minutes rest, yes.
Oh, you mean like a night's rest?
I think it says a short rest.
You get your spells back after a short rest? That doesn't make sense.
Well, it's...
I don't know whatever that bring back to life ability was. If that was a spell or an ability or what.
You mean the one that picks you from 0 to 1?
Yeah.
That you can do that at any point.
Is there anyone in the room here that looks like they could use that?
Definitely. A bunch of them.
Definitely. A bunch of them. I can only cast that, like, let's see, hold on, see.
Yeah, it's a cantrip. You can cast it constantly.
Oh yeah, it's a cantrip. I do get 2 more.
Cantrip.
Wait, hold on, because what else was a cantrip that I casted?
Light, usually.
Light. Which I casted once.
It's you get infinite amount of cantrips. You can cast as many as you want.
Alright, so I'm going to start down here, and I'm going to start helping her patient by patient, very slowly.
Yeah, she's you see this guy over here kind of open his eyes and this guy here, as he opens his eyes and awes, you keep healing people with a simple touch.
I'm just picturing the visualization of this right now. You've got the big-ass dragonborn walking down an aisle of gnomes, probably like brushing each one as he walks down the hallway. Mm-hmm.
It's literally like Green Mile, or Dead Mile. I forget what it's called.
It's Bahamut Mile. It is Green Mile.
Okay, good.
Bahamut Mile.
But yeah, so you're Green Miling it up, going. You're healing up. You're welcome, boss. That kind of thing. Okay. A lot of them seem better, and they kind of, some of them get up and leave, others kind of stay and rest for a while.
Alright.
So, what's your name to the healer person?
She says Jealous.
Sorry?
Jealous.
Jealous?
Mm-hmm.
So, Miss Jealous, since my friend, helped you out and everyone kind of looks stable, do you think you can give my bearded friend a look-see?
Yeah, blood flies on you too. from the guy she's working on. give me a dex saving throw. Reflex 8. Yeah, so you kind of try to duck and it just gets all over your face. She says, I'm still a little bit busy. And she kind of looks at him, like, dizzily on the ground. And she kind of approaches and takes a look. And and says, this would take far too long for me to do anyways.
could help them?
What's that?
Who could help them?
She says there's a priest that hangs out down south. I've been trying to get him to come here for a long time, but he never. But he's always busy looking up the singing stones.
Gaze onward.
He says he takes his hammer out and dizzily stumbles.
So I stay here and I do a couple more, and then I try to get my way out, catch up to them.
Yeah, no problem. You guys can leave as a group. Brunar kind of holding his skull.
So it was south before we left. No further information, suggested south?
Yeah, she pointed in this direction here. She says by the food court area.
The food court.
So I'm just taking a moment to, with the water right there, to splash some water on my face and try to clean up a little.
Get the blood off.
Indeed.
I will actually do the same since I was also kind of splattered.
Oh yeah, with all the people you're next to. Definitely bad. Do you do the same, Brunar?
Yes.
Not sure if you want to get dirty water into your head wound.
That's dirty water? They were what? Drinking from it.
Well, yeah, it's on the ground.
It's like, you know, pool water or a pond water. You know, there are things, you know, fish pee in it and crap like that.
Well, there's no fish in it.
Putting that into my wound.
Okay, great.
If you figure there's stalactites, it's probably full of lime and minerals and shit.
I thought it was clear drinking water. They had these pools to drink water.
No, okay, it's dripping from the ceiling. Either way, working our way down.
Cool. Keep going.
Okay. So I approach this guy. So, where is the priest? You seen him?
He kind of gets scared as this large dwarf approaches him, just covered in blood. Kind of wobbling forward, with eyes kind of crossing periodically. And he's just incredibly scared as he backs up to the wall.
Could try to intimidate him, but not in my condition.
I tap Brainier on the shoulder and I said, they said it's by the food court, by the bar, where you get the beer.
beer! Okay.
I could go for a drink right now, guys. My head is killing me.
No, that's what Brainer should be saying.
Yeah. Cool. Now, eventually you see a bunch of statues over here.
Oh, hello. The ping made me move my thing.
Hey, wait. I'll get the quickie. And I...
Quickie. A dwarven quickie is a very scary idea.
Cool. Roll me a wisdom check with disadvantage there, Brunner.
Disadvantage?
Yeah.
That's roll two times and
take the lower, yeah.
And my wisdom is, give me a sec, I'm slow.
It's plus two.
Yes.
Okay, oops, so you got a nice. Six. After a while, Doran and Zanward eventually see Brunar approaching, just rolling a keg.
Well, it's dwarven holy water, I guess.
just for the pay.
Self-medicating.
Okay, you see this guy here. Yeah, he appears to be a priestly man.
Alright, so I have a question. So it mentions if you belong to a Never mind, because that's just never mind.
Yeah, I know what you mean. You could probably get some help from him. You can use that to get some extra sway.
Alright, so yeah. I walk up to him and I say, the lady at the medical tent, I'm just going to call it, because I can't. Requested your services.
He says, oh yeah, she's always requesting that. But I'm too busy trying to figure out this stuff.
And what is... Well, hold on. Let me roll a religion check first.
Cool. You okay? You sound like you got an axe in the head.
Okay, hold on. That's better. Do I recognize anything around?
Why'd you roll twice?
Because don't I have advantage to religion?
Nope. Is it just, no, you just have a plus two.
And it's just an 8. Then
yeah. Okay. What was that religion check to do?
I was going to try to figure out if I recognize any religious symbols around here, because he's probably studying. Like, this is the star thing he's talking about.
You've definitely heard of this. This is a place called the Singing Stones. It was where vibrations would basically come through a couple of crystals, and many people thought that it was a kind of gods giving orders and teachings and things like that. But you know they've been silent for 100 years at least.
Okay. You know, these things have been silent for about, give or take, 100 years.
We can call it bio break if you guys want.
Yeah, my blood gonna explode right after the Zanward finishes his
book. Sure, sure.
Too much gnomish, yeah.
So this guy starts saying, let me tell you the story of these things. Now, it all starts about 500 years ago. No. Go ahead, Zan.
I knew you were
kidding. Yeah.
As we zone out.
Yeah.
I shall be back in 5.
So, you know, these things have been around for... it's been silent for about 100 years. The people in the medical tent right now need you now.
He says what we need is us is to be spiritually reawakened, and the only way you can do that is by getting these stones back up. He says he kind of looks to you and sees you're a priest, and he kind of sighs and says, I think we got off on the wrong foot here. I'm Pink too. And he kind of extends his tiny hand.
His name is Ping 2.
Ping 2.
Oh, Pin 2. Okay. I reach down and I like grab his hand with 2 fingers.
Your fingers are still a little big compared to his hand.
That's sad. I am Zanward. I forgot what last name I gave myself. I made this character less than a couple minutes ago.
Zanward McSnickle-Doodle.
Of Bahamut.
Bahamut? Yeah. Platinum Dragon. Good God. How can I help you?
The medical tent needs healing. I don't know what you're missing here, because I don't know, I'm not that big on dwarven religion.
He says he's a rock gnome.
Rock gnome. Rock on. But your fellow comrades are currently dying now, and without them, the town is going to be less protective, and soon the orcs could actually ravage this town. We need to save as many of those as we currently can.
He sighs and says, very well. I can see your point. I assume you just kind of stand there silent?
Kind of.
He's okay. I can.
Or I can bring him to Brainer first.
Sure. He'll look over Brainer
first, and then he can go down there.
I'm back. Sorry, I had to go.
Okay. He can clearly see that Zonwart's being a little greedy, that he might just want this guy to do it for his own benefit, rather than for everyone else. But he'll do it anyway. He kind of looks over Brenner's head, and he starts casting a spell of lesser restoration as his head kind of fixes up. So there you go. He shouldn't have any more problems with that skull fracture anymore.
Oh, perfect.
But you do still have only one HP.
But the head wound's gone, and he's got plenty of alcohol, so I'm certain he doesn't feel any pain. I go to thank Pintu, and as I do about 5 pieces of silver fall out of my hands into his.
He kind of denies and says, no, money's not necessary.
Alright. I tried being fair.
He says, if you'd really like to help, I'm searching for certain types of crystals. But we can discuss that later.
Okay.
And he kind of walks off.
Alright, so...
So...
We need to still get him his full HP.
So if we rest, that's, we lose the contract?
No. It would just be another day.
We can rest and try again.
You guys gonna try to find some place to sleep, or are you just gonna sleep in the hallway of this grand city?
Full rest. Yeah, we need the full rest.
Ask the bartender for a room.
Cool.
Three rooms.
You approach the bartender, and he kind of looks you guys up and down. It's got a movie there. And he kind of says, I really just serve alcohol into this open market. I'm not really a tavern owner.
Yeah, I might be sleeping out in the streets. I'm almost certain there's not a bed big enough for me.
He kind of nods and says, yeah, that makes sense.
Just move two beds next to each other. Or three. I'll just ask the bartender, well, do you know anyone who does offer lodging?
He kind of points down this way, and points to this building. He says, that building's been abandoned for a while, but if you're looking just for a place to sleep, that'll probably do it.
Yeah, if it's what we got, it's what we got. Let's go, boys.
Okay, this is gonna be weird.
Listen, go ahead.
You kind of push open the doors and see the following. I see crystals inlaid all over this place. It's flooded. It's definitely in decay. And you see all these tiny doors leading into rooms. You see a man up here. He's kind of like adjusting a crystal up here.
I just call out from the doorway.
He kind of gives you a wave. Hey-o.
So, what's all this then?
He says this is the, this is a Singing Stone Tavern. What are you asking about what I'm doing?
And, what are you doing?
He says I'm trying to fix these crystals so I can play them like an instrument.
Well, maybe we can give you a hand with that, but first, does the singing crystal tavern have any rooms?
He kind of points to these three.
Just gonna poke my head in each one, see what the condition's like.
Yeah, you see they're all in some decay, there's water damage, and it doesn't look very good.
Okay.
Excuse me, good sir. Sorry to bother you again, but do you perhaps have any better rooms, like a VIP or a suite?
He kind of shrugs and says, well, this isn't my place. This place was abandoned a long time ago.
What do the upstairs rooms look like?
Relatively the same.
Well, if there's any kind of... is the beds wet? Or are they just dry and falling apart?
Moldy would be the word.
Well...
We could use our bedrolls.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. It's like, well, boys, it's not exactly the Ritz, but it'll do.
Yeah.
Perfect. Cool. So you guys each take a room?
They're not big enough to fit all three of us.
Yeah, so you each have to take a room.
Yeah, I am not sleeping with the dwarf.
Good call. He's a dwarf. So, Dorne kind of walks into a comfortable room while Zandwar and Brunnar go into this tiny little thing. Kind of squeeze through the door and kind of stay down because just the roof is so low. And, it would take a little while, but eventually it hit morning.
Do we rest sufficiently for all hit die to be restored and all that?
Yeah, you guys return to full health. In addition to full health, you have all your spells back. And your HP.
Laws. I'm just asking for mechanics' sake. Is this a just level 1 adventure, or are we leveling at some point?
Level 1 adventure.
I'm sorry?
Level 1 adventure.
Okay.
Unless you guys like play that another game sometime.
Okay,
like,
no worries.
Play tomorrow or the day after or something like that.
I think wake up in the morning, Bruenor was awaken earlier and he's having his breakfast.
Great. I assume you guys are having some of the baguettes in the bag of baguettes.
Well, Dorne's probably still sleeping.
Classic Dorne. And Zonbard is dreaming about dog walking. And then he kind of wakes up from his dream about dog walking.
Yeah, okay, I'm back.
Now the question is, when he's dreaming about the dog walking, is his legs twitching, or...?
he's watching a dog sleeping whose legs are twitching.
Right.
So I'm awakened.
You guys all rested.
Okay.
He's following
everywhere I go. Alright, well.
To have another try?
Let's give it a go.
Maybe we should go talk to the lady with those fancy firebomb things, eh?
Exactly what I was thinking, but they need money for that, so why don't you and the priest over there go, and I will see if I can get a deal for the swords in the training grounds, and I'll come meet you in the shop.
I'm gonna keep one of those swords for myself.
Yeah, you took one, I took the other.
Yep.
Alright. So Dorne and I will go try to talk to the magical lady.
Swing show?
Oops. I apparently went swimming.
Oh.
Your
boots are now wet.
My boots are now wet, yes.
And Bruenor is going to the training grounds.
Cool. You gonna try to sell those swords?
Yeah.
Cool. Ooh. One guy, apparently desperate for him, pays 19 silver, or offers 19 silver. Two others offer 12 and 8.
So I take the money, give him the sword, and go to the group with my buddies later on.
Cool. You all arrive here?
Yes.
Cool.
Back my token.
So, you see that there's a door closed. It looks like the house is wrecked. Doesn't look like it's good quality.
Whorehouse?
Might be. But it looks more like Dilapidated.
Okay.
Knock politely, respectfully.
You knock, seeing
what the lady can do.
After a moment, you see a little door open at about your crotch height, and kind of somebody peeks out and asks, "Who is there? Who's there?" Little woman.
Is it the same woman?
Yeah, same woman as far as you can tell.
Striking a pose to show off the contents of the slacks at hip length.
Well, hello there, ma'am. How is such a pretty lady like you doing today?
You see her, she closes the sheet. Or she closes the little slit.
Just wait a moment to see if she opens the door.
Yeah, the door opens after a moment. She offers you to come in. As you look inside, you see it looks much nicer on the inside than it does on the out. It doesn't look like the rest of the building, so it looks like this place was survived much better than the rest. Although it's still quite small, Zarnwar gets kind of prepared to get down again as he enters in. You guys can see weapons and clothing and items all over the place, as well as small vials of potions, and most of them under glass.
Wow, this place is schnazzy. It's got a nice home, miss.
She says, thank you. I've been trying to keep this place safe since Blingdenstone fell.
Well, I just want to say, thank you for your help the other day. You really roasted them orcs.
She says, it's no problem. I try to do my best. And it looked like you guys needed the help.
About that, actually. We're wondering if you might have anything that we could use to help us out. Supplies, some of those nifty fire potion things that you've got. Those would be marvelous.
She shrugs and says, unfortunately, that was my last one.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Do you have anything else kind of like that?
She says she could perhaps sell you some potions of healing.
And I hesitate to ask, but how much might those be?
500 silver apiece.
So 500 silver is 10 gold?
No,
50 gold still. Alright. Okay. Yeah. Mental breakdown.
Boys, how much gold do you have on you, eh?
Including mine. I have 2 gold. Maybe less.
So 20 silver?
Yeah.
Cool. Despite you just receiving 39.
So they changed the 10 silver is no longer 1 gold?
No, that's how it works.
So I have 40 silver plus 100 silver, which I started.
So 140 silver.
Yeah.
Just 14 gold.
14 gold, yeah.
Yeah.
Brain fart as well.
And our last companion?
I have about 9 gold left.
Alright.
Well, if we pool our resources, I think we could afford maybe just one. Is there anything we can perhaps do for you, ma'am, that would convince you to lower the price a bit?
She says, I have been having trouble recently with some of the elementals.
Elementals? What are those?
She says, you've never heard of them? She kind of points through the wall here. She says, to the east of here, there is a raging elemental. It is causing us great distress. And they call it Ogamark's Bane.
Just look over to Xanwar. It's like, you have any idea what that might be? Because Doran has no fucking clue about elementals.
Sure.
I'm going to assume I have very little clue.
Do you have Arcana?
No.
Then yeah, you have a little clue. Remember.
Let's see, what are the skills I have? I know Arcana is not one of them.
Can you roll on intelligence checks if you don't have it trained?
You can. I don't generally allow it though.
Okay.
What are those elementals anyway?
What's that?
Those beasts that we encountered yesterday?
Itas? Do you mean the orcs? The undead orcs?
They weren't, after the usual orcs, we encountered some weird orcs. What was it again, Zanwart? Zombies?
Zombies.
She kind of shrugs and says, yes, I heard they had some problems when they opened up the Great Hall again. But this is a different issue. She says that a long time ago we actually created a seal that made a lot of them slaves to us. But doing that created a monster of gravel and dirt, and that caused him to a constant rebel to attack us, and now we're having some serious issues with him.
Yeah, I know, eh? Do you know if there's anything that this creature wants, or any way to reason with him?
She nods, and she says she thinks he's trying to destroy the thing that enslaves all the other, other elementals, and binds them to the world. I forget the name, she says.
Do you know? That sounds like an interesting angle. So
I do have a history skill. Can I try rolling that?
Yes. Note that it would have to be very high for this.
Okay, I'm gonna note. So it's just a d20?
Yep, d20 plus intelligence. Plus one if you have the skill.
Okay, so plus one for the skill, and do I even have an intelligence? No, I don't.
It's a shame.
I know nothing.
Yeah. Unfortunately, in your readings, you never heard of us.
So, that does sound like an interesting angle. Who might know what that device is?
Well, she says it's, I know what it is, I just don't know what it's called. You see her kind of tap her nose, and she says, oh, Entremach's Boon, that's what it's called. She says it is a powerful artifact that keeps together tamed, all the elementals.
I haven't seen anything around here that looks like what you're describing as an elemental.
She kind of nods and says, well, it depends on where you've been. We keep, since the fall of the city, they've all gone wild. And she kind of points this way. And she says, but they're all that way, outside of the reclaimed part of the city.
So they're out of control anyway.
She nods.
So where is this Entremach's Boon?
She says it's just north. But she also says that it's definitely very important.
Alright, so I just turn to my companions and just mention, I was like, well, if they're out of control anyway, maybe we can just give this boon or break this boon to get the big elemental to go away.
She says that would be a terrible thing to do.
Because then smaller ones would be...
Well, they're already out of control, no?
Yes, but once we destroy Edgemark's Bane, then Ogremark's Bane, they'll go back to normal. As far as I can tell.
Well, has anyone tried to fight this Bane?
They shake their head and say, she says that all of the, as far as I know, all of the, what's the word, elementals, when they're all connected psychically, or through, or spiritually, or something, I don't know, but when you attack one, the rest know, and then they all pounce upon you, and they're just too strong to fight. She says you would need some sort of, elemental, wizard or something to help you.
I don't suppose you might know where one is in this place.
She kind of gives a smile and she says, "Well, I do know of certain creatures that are known to be very powerful with the elementals, but they're generally not friendly to humans, or rather, not friendly to us."
Well, you're in luck. None of us are humans or gnomes.
She kind of gives a smile and says, "Exactly. So, if you would like to help, we could. You would definitely earn this old lady's thanks."
All right. Well, where can we find some of these creatures you speak of?
She says they're called the Pecks. They are these small humanoid looking creatures. They're elementals of Earth. She kind of points that way, and she says, what did she say? She says that the old forges were taken over by them, and they seem to be kind of, that's where they live, in the old forges.
Alrighty, so boys, we have a choice. We can go find us some packs. We could try to go down the hole with the undead baddies. Or we could try to find us some orcs.
Well, I would be for revenge on those crazy undead things. But we need the help. Like, what could harm these creatures? What could help us?
She kind of touches her nose and says, "What kind of creatures are you fighting?"
Are
you talking about fighting elementals, or?
Well, the zombies that we ran into earlier, at least that's what Zamord's calling them. The only one who actually managed to do anything to him was our dwarven buddy here with his axe.
And she kind of looks to his axe and says, "Yeah, that's because he's probably chopping their limbs off. Most undead can't be killed without can't be killed, so you must simply dismember them."
Yeah, just kind of backhands onward in the chest with the back of my hand. It's like, now we know.
Yeah, see, your little stinks are no help for this kind of creature. Weaklings.
He says with a big tear in his skull.
No, it's cute.
Yeah, I know, but it's still funny.
Would I be likely to find any hand axes or other small, light axes that I could use, like two-handed weapons? Fighting, rather.
While you're in here, you actually see under the case is a one-handed hand axe.
Oh, I have a hand axe.
Oh, I see you got something that catches my eye here. Is there anything special about it?
She gives out a small laugh, and she says, "Yes, it's been enchanted."
Enchanted?
Enchantment!
And just kind of like wringing my hands a little. And how much is something like that worth?
She says if you can't afford a small potion, you couldn't afford this. But she says... What?
Go ahead. I was just going to say if there's anything that we have in trade, perhaps.
She's going to say if you agree to take down Ogamark Spain, though, I could think about it.
Okay.
Our way is cut then.
with the armory or the whatever it was in the northeast that we were selling the weapons off? What are the chances of finding some small regular hand axes up there?
It's low.
I have a hand axe.
Yeah, it's low because you're waiting in line.
Yeah, Bruno does have a hand axe on you.
Okay. Alright, without two of them, I'm probably better off with the one weapon, so that's fine. I'm just trying to optimize for those guys. So, what...
Bruiser whispers to Dorin, get info. I don't want to get fucked up again without knowing what this fucking guy's.
So, my very brave and courageous dwarf friend here, he's curious if you know anything more about these zombies or this ancient keep that we're supposed to take a look at. Do you know any other ways in or what we might find there?
She says the only other way in would be through the front door. And the last time you saw it, it had a bunch of... You managed to see the door, but it was just piles and piles of skulls and dead bodies were in front of it. You assume that somebody tried to open it up, but couldn't. Besides that, she says slashing weapons tend to work very well against the undead. Against the fleshy ones, anyway.
Animals, would we have a problem with our weapons?
Not with Brynar's weapons. But Zanwart's were bad.
Yeah, I have bludgeoning and piercing.
Yeah. Bludgeoning's not bad, but it's not as good as slashing.
Damn it! Me and my piercing.
You're a rogue. And then you're like, hey, let's attack undead. That'll be our thing.
Well, I didn't know they were undead. I thought those were the actual orcs. Oh well. Lesson learned. I'm kind of interrogated out at the moment, guys. Do you have any other questions you want to ask?
No.
So, what are we doing? Are we going straight for the orcs or for the elementals? In any case, we need to find the weapons appropriate for each. Well, like, the elementals need the slashing weapons. That's what she told us.
No, undead needs slashing weapons.
Undead needs slashing weapons.
No, yeah. I asked for the elementals, anything we need to know about the elementals.
For the elementals, she said, you would definitely need to hurt Argamok, you would definitely need magic. And, she says if
the only magic person.
Yeah, she says if you require it, you can use the hand axe.
We can acquire hand axes, but you guys can't acquire magic. And even then, I only have one offensive magic.
Her hand axe that she's offering is magic.
But we have to kill it to get the hand axe.
Oh, no, she's offering it right now.
Okay. But then that's still only two of us. The third one's just SOL.
True.
So we would be needing to hire the magician she was talking earlier.
The pecs, the creatures who don't like the gnome, that don't like the gnomes. I think all said and done, for simplicity's sake, I have a slashing weapon now. It's not optimal, but it'll work.
Well, with Brunar's second one, you can have two. Which means you guys have a bludgeoning weapon and three slashing.
I was thinking, as far as the zombies goes, if I'm using the, word just eludes me. The weapon I pulled off from the undead guys, you said that was going to have to be a two-handed weapon, so I can't use it.
Yeah, for you. For Zanwar, it'd be one-handed. Or two-handed, you get 1d10. Or two-handed, you get 1d10, yeah.
Right.
Same thing with Dorne.
Alright, so I'm thinking, since we know how to deal with the zombies now, we either go after them or the orcs. I'm thinking these elementals are really bad news.
She says, you should definitely go after the elementals.
Yeah, but she has a bias.
That's true. She's also in the room that you're talking in.
But I don't say that out loud.
Well, then you guys should probably leave, because you're talking to each other.
No, okay. That's OOC.
I figured we were in a huddle of some sort.
Yeah. Oh, well, there is no OOC. It
gives us a weapon to go for the elementals, right?
She already gave it to you.
Oh, she gave it to us.
Yep.
Oh.
That's because you already said you would do it.
Oh.
Okay. We didn't say when.
So we will totally take care of the elementals in due time.
Cool.
Okay.
What are hand axes in next?
1d4? 1d6.
1d6. Alright, so I don't even have to change anything. Great. Oh, one of those is magic, right?
Yep, so 1d6 plus 1 attack and plus 1 to damage.
Alright, and then I get one of the other axe, one the axe that Doran picked up, or the scimitar.
Short sword.
Okay, short sword.
Well, no, it's a long sword, rather. It's a machete, essentially.
Okay. And then that's a 1d8 in one hand.
Yeah, or right, 1d10
in both. I'm going to use my war hammer and say I have
a... Oh, so you're just going to use your war hammer or a weapon, because it's the same roll?
Well... I was just going to use Warhammer macro. I wasn't going to.
Yeah, perfect. Yeah. Definitely perfect.
And I will be sticking to my great axe.
Smart man.
Alrighty, off to undead we go.
Off to go. It's off to undead we go. We go.
Keep. And this time, keep scanning and not beginning anything without. Notifying us, Doran.
Well, don't call me a weakling. He spurred me on. That was planned.
Well, I'm gonna imitate him against doing this same thing again.
Right, before you run up there, Zenward, let me scout around here a little.
Alright.
Okay. So, being stealthily quiet and kind of looking around.
I don't see anything as of yet.
Okay, since we were not able to really... Two of them came from down this way.
You wouldn't see anything right now because you wouldn't have a light. You need Zanrod with you.
Right. Oh, okay.
So
you look down, you see this place has really not been updated like the rest has. You see rotting stairways and old areas. You see the thing that I mentioned before. That's the gate. Just with piles of bodies.
Hey, Zanwad, do me a favor. Cast your light spell on this, would you? I'm going to pull out a copper coin.
Do you have a copper coin on you?
Yes, I do.
Good.
Alright, so I take it off of my spearhead, because I can only have it on one thing, and I put it on the copper coin.
And I chuck it as far as I can this way.
Cool. You chuck it that way, kind of reveal some of the area, but, you don't really see anything.
Okay. And I just kind of follow where the light shines so I can see what's here in a little more detail.
Yeah. You enter in. It's just more splintered wood. Destroyed rubble. Now you look up there. And you see that. Are you looking for anything specific or particular?
Just making sure that there's nothing to run at our backs, basically.
Nothing that you see.
Alright. Pick up my coin. Yeah, I'm just gonna hold the coin in my palm, so if I need to extinguish it I can just close my hand.
Cool. Brunar, what were you saying?
I'm getting close to the hole. I'm trying to listen to the water pouring in, how deep it is. Do I listen to sounds from down there?
Sure, you can give me a perception check. Might be an intelligence check, but whatever's good.
Intelligence or wisdom?
Let's say intelligence. So plus 0 for you. I think it might be minus 1, actually.
Minus 1. Yeah, now I get a 14.
yeah, you think it's probably a good like 30-40 feet down.
And no other sounds like growling and shit like that?
Like what?
Drowning?
Howling, walking,
growling.
None that you hear, no.
Yeah. Really, where did I go?
I'm assuming,
went down.
I'm assuming you guys want to go down.
Go down the hall.
Okay. You guys look down and you see it looks like the following. Who goes first? The dwarf? Dwarf wanna go first?
The dwarf, yes.
Flop, 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 flop.
The tank that dies in one hit. Okay, I lost my token again. Somebody.
Oh, I'm sorry.
What?
Bottom left, approximately.
Okay. I will try and find it.
Oh, are you not, when I do this, you're not being dragged?
Yeah, because I was dragging myself.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
So, what's all this shit around?
It seems to be just rubble. You see some broken paintings and destroyed chairs and tables. It seems that there's a lot of stuff on the ground with stone, but it's most likely have come from the roof.
Okay. So are they close for the whisper, or should I whistle?
Whistle would be appropriate.
Yeah. As the silent as I can.
Alright.
From this point on, I have my great axe at my hands.
Yeah. Zanwell, Doran.
Doran will climb down to the... about midway down and whisper down,
Rona, you still alive down there?
The dwarf cannot die in the deep. Don't worry.
Right.
Yep, he's still alive. He'll hop down and find a corner to hide.
And then I will come down.
Cool. You guys come down, you see that there's one exit. And once again, the roof just covered with rubble. Everything looks destroyed or rotten. What do you guys do?
Alright.
Well, I haven't made it down yet, apparently.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Is the door open?
The door appears closed.
Listen at the door.
Cool. You listen and you hear nothing.
Alright.
At least that's cool. Now without a check, you hear nothing. You hear nothing.
Right. Open the door. Oh, there's an army. Yeah. Glowing coin, palm in my hand so the darkest, it's not lit.
Cool.
Just kind of covering with my palm. Crack the door open slowly and as quietly as possible.
Cool.
At least I will be able to see something.
It appears to be a hallway.
Alright. Opening my hand just enough so I can see the ground in front of me and maybe hold it up if I hear anything. Just trying to kind of scout around, trying to be quiet while I do it.
Cool. You look forward and you see it appears to be just the end of the hallway. What are you saying, Bruno?
One question about mechanics. Is a fighter able to stealth in D&D Next?
Oh, of course. For how I do it is, or how they say you should do it, and I like, is at least if at least 50% or more of the group succeeds on the stealth check, then the whole group passes and everyone's fine.
Yeah, I was thinking like peeking around corners without.
That wouldn't even require a stealth check. That would just be you peeking around the corner. But it would be moving, like, try if there was like a monster right here and you wanted to move from here to here without him hearing you, that would be a stealth check.
Ah, okay. So maybe I should check corners. I can see in the dark.
Yeah, and, all right.
Yeah, he starts moving forward without fear of anything happening.
And as I'm moving forward, my ears are open wide, cool. I guess.
Give me a perception check, and that'll be your standard one for while I'm checking around.
Dorne would probably be following like 10 feet behind or so.
Cool.
So I don't know if he needs to hear anything.
Oh man!
Hear that? Nice roll.
Oh, that's just the sound of this place. It's very eerie.
That would be awesome.
He perceives all the things.
Yeah. But yeah, you do hear creaks and things like that coming from the hallway, and they kind of get reflected off the stone.
Dwarves are stone-ish by nature, right?
That's
they
true.
They kind of know how to deal with echoes.
That just means they get advantage on a check.
So Bruno moves towards the corner, picking around corners.
Cool.
And as I was saying, Dorne just keeps 10 feet behind.
You see the fog.
I signal that this side is clear. Move. Oh, shit. Hey, Dorne. Do you think there might be traps in here? I forgot about that.
A smart man always expects a trap.
So how do we search for traps as we move?
Well, I can move up next to Brunner and open my palm to let some light out. Yeah. And we'll just be... I don't know how you do it, passively.
Yeah, just give me a perception check and that'll be you looking around. You can also give me a search check if you'd like. If you like that feel around. Cool. So you're feeling around things as you move forward.
And it's wisdom again?
No, you're fine, Bruno. You got your 21. So you just gotta stick with that. So you're gonna be trying to keep your eyes open while Bruno keeps his hands feeling towards everything.
And peeking around this corner as well.
he takes out a scimitar. You peek around this corner, and you see this.
Yeah. Seems it's going around. So let's go this way again. And check what I see from here.
Cool.
Yeah, this is gonna take a while, I think.
Assuming you guys go at your pace, yes.
Two skeletons we probably shouldn't be seeing.
No.
Skeleton? I'm out of here.
It's just a flicker of the shadows. There's nothing there.
And this
No.
Run right away.
Ever since they added that actual motion when someone moves around instead of just showing up there, one of my GMs has made a point of having just a shit ton pile of ghosts on one side of the map. They just flies across the party periodically.
Okay, you get to there?
Yeah.
You see what appears to be three gnomish skeletons. They're just kind of leaned against the wall, falling on their butts, holding onto their armor. Their bones broken and pierced.
They're not animated, they're just lying down?
They do not appear animated, no.
How did you describe their armor and limbs?
They appear to be, they have broken bones, their weapons are, they appear to be like fine made, but they're all old and decrepit and ruined. But they got a shield and some ruined leather armor that's been used as a home probably a couple of times and ripped apart. And they have small bucklers. That are also made of ruined armor. Or ruined steel.
Who's onward to take a look, take a peek?
Alright, anytime we see a couple of corpses with broken bones piled in a corner, I would pay extra attention to checking for traps every 5 feet.
Cool. Once again, you just keep that search check up, and that'll be your search.
Alright, that's fine.
Yeah. So not going to make you do a check every 5 seconds, that would be silly.
Are we continuing this way, or are we going down? Here.
It
It's more interesting this way.
Okay. And slowly, Bruno walks.
I'm sorry, Zanward, you're very quiet. I almost didn't hear you there.
Can I do like a knowledge religion to see if they're animated or not?
Sure. Although, perception check would probably be more appropriate.
Oh, we got insight, is that the same thing?
Sure, give me an insight check. See if they're just pretending to be alive.
D20 plus be dead. Insight is wisdom.
Do they have the dark magic in next?
As far as you can tell, they're just dead.
As far as I can tell, they're made out of plastic.
True. It's a spooky spider.
Ruiner takes this corner.
You see the following.
You go ahead and go first.
Do you think we should smash these skeletons now that they're not moving? They're not dwarves anymore, anyway.
Yeah, a good 15 feet away. I don't know how much detail we can see on these guys.
Oh,
if
yeah.
If their bones are plenty. Broken, they're probably not getting up.
They're that much destroyed.
Any of their equipment still serviceable?
You look through, you don't see any.
Okay, moving right along.
I'm going to move along, but I'm going to keep my eye on those until we're out of here.
Cool.
Downwards?
Okay, you look downwards and you see the following.
Oh, well, that looks like a big boss room. Let's go there.
Yeah, wide open spaces is not a rogue-friendly thing.
Let's check around first. Right.
Now I've got Dixie Chicks song stuck in my head.
What?
I got Dixie Chicks song stuck in my head. Wide open spaces. It's a good thing I'm not a bard.
This is a let's search. I don't like dead ends. Like hidden doors or anything.
Cool. Give me some search checks. 16 for Doran. Doran, with that, you find that there is a certain button you can push right along this wall.
Alright, I point it out to everyone else and I tell them to stand back.
Oh yeah, I'm definitely going to take a couple steps back.
Let's see, do I have the ubiquitous 10-foot pole? Yeah.
You kind of see these guys in your corner of your eye and start going back and forth between them.
I'm just going nuts here.
Yeah. So you gonna press the button?
Just checking equipment real quick.
Do you know, is it a trap or is it a lever that opens a hallway?
It's a button.
It's kind of like a it's like a stone. It's like a stone piece of stone that you're able to push in. So it's kind of like a button.
All right, that's kind of weird. Seem
like a trap.
It's kind of weird, but I've got a shovel. I'm just looking for something with a long haft. Actually, wait. Zonward. Pass me one of your javelins, eh?
Pass me one of your javelins.
I'm going to come up here, give him a javelin, and step back so I can still make sure I can see everything.
Cool.
Alright, and, holding it is by the very tip as much as I can. I'm going to push that button from as far away as I humanly can.
Cool. You push it in. You kind of have to put your weight into it because it's hard to do with a stick. Eventually, it slides in. You start hearing mechanical things going around. The clunk. Chuck, 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 chuck.
Oh, that's not
clunk.
Good.
Chuck, 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 chuck. Clunk, clunk. And after about 5 seconds, you see a little ka-chink open up. Chink.
Okay.
Chink.
Ah, I knew it. This must have been built by dwarves. Let's go.
Do we hear anything coming from this new passage?
From the new one? No. Although air does kind of pile into it.
I like how you had to qualify. The new one? No.
Alright, before Doran gets too far, I'm going to take the, what's probably to him, the extra long stick and put the javelin back.
Cool.
Yeah, you can have that back.
Yeah, here, catch!
And in the same manner, I hate that sound.
I know, it's great, isn't it?
Well, I told you my story about the Call of Cthulhu session I had.
Yeah. Okay, you look for it, and you see this appears to be some sort of jail slash room for holding munitions and food and things of that nature. You can see some barrels have leaked and caused some moss onto the ground. You see a pretty fine looking painting of some sort of rock gnome. You see him wearing a certain crown. In addition, some food that has long ago rotted.
Any movement?
Any movement? Not to your draconic eyes can see.
All right. Any?
Hey, you see a portcullis splitting the room in half, or bars rather, mm-hmm. And you see a small gnome on the other side. Dead skeleton.
Any of these containers intact?
One of them appears to be.
All right. Pull the crowbar out, crack that sucker open.
Okay, it's currently on its side, so spills everywhere.
All right.
You tilt it upwards and you open it up and you kind of give a smell, and it appears to be a large vat of perfume.
Oh God! Close that up immediately.
Cool.
Perfume, that's money. And as I say that, I'm studying the painting.
Cool. You see the eyes seem to follow you wherever you go.
Must have been a good painter.
What? Really? The eyes follow me?
They seem to follow you, yes, wherever you go.
Having noticed you. This, Thorn is going to run his hands along the edge of the painting to see if it can come away from the wall at all.
It does come away from the wall, and as it does, you see it's just a regular painting.
There's nothing behind it, no eye holes or...
Nope. Definitely. No, this ain't no Scooby-Doo, son.
I was about to say that.
this isn't Scooby-Doo.
Okay, go ahead. I'm gonna slash and destroy this painting. I don't like it.
It's Feel really free. Good. What? So feel free to destroy the painting.
Yeah, I'm Thorn, just...
Thorn being a little paranoid, just going to step away from that.
The painting explodes in magical energy. Nope, you just kind of rip it in half with your axe, and you're kind of like, huh, probably could have sold that. Meh.
Yes, but we would have had to have carried it.
Yeah, that's a big painting.
And fine art is hard to sell.
That looks me in this strange way, I don't like it.
You kind of look at the crown, you see it looks similar to the one that the other guy was wearing, only this one was made out of gold.
The other one was made out of aluminum foil.
Essentially.
So that's what we're looking for.
Basically. Yep, you look and you see what you're looking for, essentially.
For shits and giggles, the portion of the painting with the crown, ripped as it is, I'm going to curl that up and tuck it into my pack. It's a memento.
And you see this large iron door closed.
Okay. Check for traps.
Cool. You notice none.
Alright.
You can't find any traps.
Right.
You can't see any traps.
I don't detect no traps.
Yeah.
The whole dungeon is a trap. It's just one giant mimic.
Oh, that'd be good.
But I'm immune to acid, so I'm fine with it.
Not immune, you just take less damage from it.
Oh yeah, I guess it's resistant.
So when you're doused in it, you're going to die by it. Okay, you get to there and you can see this. There's another door on the other side.
Is there a door locked?
This door, most certainly it's locked. Locked in half.
I'm going to try to change that.
Give it to me. Give me a thievery check.
That's unfortunate.
Sleight of hand, 11. A lot of rolls. You try for about 5 minutes can't really get it to work. Like, you can try again.
Yeah, I'm gonna take another moment to double check myself for traps. I don't see shit.
Again, you cannot find any traps. So it's your critical one.
How long does this take?
Hmm?
How long does all this trying to open take? Like 3 minutes?
Five minutes?
5 minutes. Bruno is very impatient and takes a slash at the lock, I guess.
I'm gonna do this bronze bottom style.
You gonna try to bend the bars?
Yeah, that's strength, right?
Strength.
Using the weapon to break it and
stuff. Oh, you want to use your weapon too?
No, because that would endanger the weapon.
Yeah, that would really endanger the weapon.
Yeah. So, what's the bend bars?
Yep, just strength.
Okay.
Oh, yep, you managed to rip one of the bars right off. So you kind of walk through to the other side, and you kind of look at Doran.
I just sigh, hang my head, and tuck my tools away.
That's when you get hit by a trap. No.
And this is how it's done, weakling.
Although, when you get to the side, you do notice that there's a hole right there.
That's a hole.
It's just no elegance.
And slowly and aware of my environment, I proceed to this corner to pick while I nod for Doran to investigate the hole and...
While he's checking that, I'm checking out the body first.
Cool. You approach the body. I will tell you what you find on said body. Which is the following vis-a-vis what I'm about to say.
Vis-a-vis? Are we recording?
What's up?
Vis-a-vis? Concordantly?
Concordantly. The following. Yep, you look at the little gnome on the ground, and you don't seem to find anything on him.
Alright, carefully looking down the hole.
You look down the hole, you're using your little light.
Yep.
Cool. You use a little light and you look down, and it seems to go down pretty far.
Okay. Paying no respects to the dead, I shall take a convenient toe bone or shin bone or something and drop it down the hole.
Cool. I'm assuming.
I will give him a dirty look when he does that.
Okay. You drop it down, and after a few moments, you hear a little tick tick.
Oh, he's not gonna miss it. And that's a pretty deep hole.
Yeah, you don't think it's that deep. Probably only about like 20, 30 feet.
Yeah. Well, to a half, 3 foot halfling.
But it kind of bends, so it's hard to get the light down there.
Hey, what's going on?
Unfortunately, you definitely don't think that Zanward or Brunar could get down there.
That was something I was going to bring up. I don't think I could.
Oh well.
How does
it smell?
How does it smell? It smells like a dank hole, but so does the whole place.
Okay.
The smell of old alcohol really is kind of wafting over the entire area, so you don't really get anything.
Okay. It's no obvious privy pit or something like that.
Hey, yeah. Doran, what's going on? Do you want to go down there? What's the holdup?
I'm not really.
Okay.
What's down this way?
I see a door. A large metal door.
Do your magic.
Oh, step aside. Check for traps.
Go for it. You do not detect any.
Listen at the door. Seventeen perception.
You're going to do what?
Sorry, I'm just listening at the door.
Oh, listen at the door. You don't hear anything.
All right. And I shall proceed to pick the lock.
Cool.
Did you try the door handle first?
Sleight of hand deception. Silly. is thievery on there anywhere?
I think sleight of hand is your kind of end all be all thievery.
Cool. It'll function as the same thing for us. Yeah. Although.
No, sleight of hand is the pick lock slash pickpocket.
Thievery tools would be it in this scenario, which you have.
I do have thieves tools, yes.
Yeah, exactly. So we're going to use that anyway. You find the hallway after you open it up.
Bow and gesture to the dwarf. After you, good dwarf.
Peeking around the corner once more.
Cool. You peek around the corner and you instantly see
nothing.
Large table. A large rotting table with many cracks inside of it. Very worn. See some poop kind of on top of it.
Poop?
Yeah, it looks like guano.
Oh, okay.
Does anyone recognize it as such?
Probably not. I don't have a nature check.
I don't think any of us know what that is. It smells real bad.
You do see over here is another door.
Where's the other door? Okay.
Do you hear anything, like chittering or...
You do hear some chittering, yes.
Okay. Small-ass halfling hears chittering and thinks, hey, you guys go first.
Don't you want to check this area first, make sure it's safe, before we open the door down there?
And all we have is the one room with the table in it, right?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm searching the table then, I guess.
Cool.
For any,
yeah,
you know, anything under it.
Cool. Give me a roll.
Yeah, now I get the good roll.
Yeah, underneath it you find there's a small corpse of a Snurf Neblin, or a rock gnome.
I said the...
You find a small rotting pack.
Rotting pack. What is that exactly?
Doran looks up and he can see clearly there's a large hole in the roof above you.
Guys, you might want to look up.
Not now, Doran. We're looting.
But guys...
Alright, so I look up into the hole.
Yeah. With your bright light, you shine into the hole, and you see a bunch of skittering bats kind of sleeping.
Uh-huh. So we might try to do the rest of this quietly.
I didn't understand.
Did I find anything on the corpse?
You find a small crumbling pack.
Ah, a pack. Like a sack.
Like a sack, yeah.
So, slowly, I approach the door and nod to Dory.
Where was the Smurf Neblin's corpse?
In the hole in the table.
Yeah, you kind of hear the wood creak as you bend for it, Brunner. But luckily no one seems to wake up from it.
Did the door open?
No, that was a creak from the wood.
The table.
Yeah. Doran kind of looks up and he kind of hears, you kind of see some of the bats kind of twitch, but none of them open their eyes and get up.
So, does he successfully pull the backpack out?
Yep.
Maybe you should step away from the table for a bit to see what's in the pack.
And I move slowly again back there to check it out.
Okay, you look inside the pack and you find that there is about 27 silver coins.
Nice.
Hey, quickly grab those before anyone even sees anything. How many did you say?
27. Give me a very good sleight of hand check.
That is a very good sleight of hand check.
That is a very good sleight of hand check. You manage to take a handful before the rest see. So you probably get about 10 coins out of that before anyone notices.
Alright. Oh, that's 17 coins. I'll hold on to those.
Okay, how the fuck did he... I was checking the bug.
Hey, you found loot. The halfling's gonna be there.
This crumbling bag has a hole in the bottom. That's weird.
Funny how that happens. Were there any egresses from this room?
Yeah, you see this one here. Boop.
South. Okay. Rinse and repeat. Listen, check, pick.
Cool. You don't need to pick this one, it seems.
Okay, so listen at the door.
Cool. You not hear anything on the other side.
Open the door slowly, carefully.
Cool. Boop. It opens up.
Step just inside to give room for the dwarf.
The dwarf starts looking around. He sees the following. You see a door. Yes, right there.
Let's check this out before we go to the big room.
Okay. What do you do there, Bruno? Or Doran or Xander?
I'm waiting for Dorin to come open this door.
I'm just kind of eyeing the open area to the right, keep my ears open.
Cool.
And rinse, repeat.
Doran listens at the door. You listen, you actually hear voices coming from the other side. Or just one voice in particular.
Clear enough to discern?
Yes, but not in a language you can understand.
So I back away quiet. It's like, hey, there's someone speaking over there, but I don't understand what they're saying.
I try to listen in case, just in case it's Dorvish, but I highly doubt it.
Cool.
I don't think it's Draconic. I'm not going to try.
Okay, so you guys find the dragon on the other side.
I was going to say, it's your long friend, the Onyx Elder Dragon.
It's hey, my mother!
Don't attack me, child. Okay, cool. So yeah, what do you guys want to do? You have a door in front of you.
Just extinguish any light sources. Or at least cover them up in any way. And as quietly and carefully as I possibly can, I'm going to open the door, trying not to be noticed.
Alright, cool. Give me a Roro. Ooh, that's a really good stealth check. So good I can't cause you to fail horribly. Alright, you open it up. I don't think anything heard you. The voice gets louder because the door is now open, but you cannot understand it still.
Are there any light sources in this room?
There are none.
Alright, so continuing to be stealthy, the light coin in hand revealing just enough in front of me to see about 10 feet, 15 feet.
Cool.
And I will move just far into the room to see around the corner.
Cool. You start shining it around the corner, and as you do, you hear something on the something say something. And who might you be? In common.
Having read too many fantasy novels as a young halfling, I keep my mouth shut.
Have you come to pay homage to Farron Nicostas, the conqueror and rightful king of Blingdenstone?
I turn around behind me and kind of open the palm of my hand so the light flashes behind me. sure. to signal Zan and Bruner and wave them in. Like, you get the idea. And I'll call out from behind the corner, keeping out of sight. what did he say his name was?
Farron.
Farron? But of course, who doesn't know of the great Farron?
Yes. You kind of, I'm assuming you can light up. So anyway, Brunar can see that there is a drow. Appears to be decrepit. His skin's kind of falling off. His eyes are glowing red. He's kind of sitting on this a throne that's a little too small for him, with his feet up on top of the skeleton, or the dead skeleton body of Snurf Neblin, with a crown, a golden crown on his head. And he kind of just rests there, and he has a smirk on his face. You see two Snurf Neblin guards, or skeletons, as well as two drow guards that are also undead.
Alright, so are the drow zombies and the Snurf Neblin skeletons?
Yep. Snurf Neblin. Okay. Snurf Neblin.
It's more fun just watching Smurf. People try to pronounce them.
It's such a fun word to say. Snurf Neblin. Snurf Neblin.
Okay.
Did he? What's his response to me saying that? Of course, we've heard of him.
So if he says, "Welcome, come pay homage to the crown."
Nudge Bruner and kind of push him into the way.
And as I'm moving past him, I whisper him, "What am I expected to do? Kill them or
be your charming self? Chat him up.
Be your charming self."
So hey,
As Bruner's passing, I whisper to Zonward,
"When the dwarf fucks it up, run in there swinging."
Stupid. Yes, we say, Bruner.
Hey, draw. That's a fine helm, crown you have over there. I'll be taking that.
He takes it off the skeleton. He kind of places it on his own head. He says, you see him get kind of angry, and he kind of turns to his skeletons, and he gives you like a Frenchman's wave, and says, "Take them away," as he points to you, and you see these guards start to go towards you to push you out of here. So they step down the dais.
As they move, I'm gonna place my back on this,
pillar?
And get ready to attack as soon as they're close, I guess.
Cool. So roll for initiative.
Initiative. I think we're going
all the good rolls at battle. Yeah. How many rounds does Bruno survive this time?
I'm guessing two.
It takes two for the drow to come?
No, I'm assuming you're going to survive for two rounds.
Oh, come on. I hate you.
What? Music? Is that it?
No, you rolled an 18. I'm like, I get to go. No, I don't.
Yeah, sorry, man. I roll high and often.
Just before the battle starts, I should get an opportunity attack when they enter the out of the initiative. I mean,
when they
get close.
Yeah, when they get close, as if they were here and then they left. That would be the issue. But they're just going towards you, so that wouldn't cause attack opportunity.
Uh huh.
Unless you had like a weapon that had reach, and you had certain feats. Farron gets an 18.
Unless it means he's preparing an action to swing as soon as they get in range.
Yeah, that's what I said. As soon as they start moving against me, I move the one block there.
Okay, sure. But that would also mean that they would prepare actions to attack, etc. Yeah. But I'll allow it this time.
It's hard, I guess.
Yeah, go for it. Give me an attack. A 16 on the little skeleton here.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. You managed to bash him. Give me a roll. 11 damage. Nice. Yeah, you managed to rip his shield right off his hand. Descending. Okay, cool. I see Farron get up, crown in hand, and he charges over to you. And he starts slicing you up. Ooh, or what did he do his energy drain move?
Oh, goodness. This is going to be...
Yeah, let's do energy drain. Give me a dex saving throw as he grabs onto you or tries to grab.
Dex from the dwarf, huh?
Yep. That's a plus one modifier.
I have a plus zero modifier. No, wait, do I?
Oh, just barely doesn't make it. Yeah, just
that seems way too strong for us. Maybe we should run.
Okay, so 7 of your hit points just are ripped out of you. And that's from your maximum hit points. Meaning your total health is now 6. So you're full HP, if that's any consolation.
But now your full HP is 6.
Essentially.
Oh, perfect.
Okay.
Basically means I cannot be healed to my maximum.
It doesn't mean, though, that you can't use your second wind to get 1d6 plus 1 extra health on top of your health.
But if I receive a potion, I will heal only for this 6.
Exactly. Which is unfortunate. Zandward.
Alright, so I really don't want her to notice me just yet, so I'm going to kind of sneak behind this pillar.
Note that you wouldn't be able to see unless you're holding your light. If you're holding your light, then they can see you.
Well, Durin has the coin.
Okay, cool.
And I'm going to cast Bless. So choose any number of creatures within range, blah, blah, blah. Whenever a target makes an attack roll...
Is the range 25 feet?
If range is 25 feet.
Cool.
Cool. They can add... So whenever
plus 1d4 to all attacks and saving throws.
Yes.
But that does not include damage. So it's only attacks.
Right. But, cool. You know, considering we have this life-draining bitch...
That's a good idea, yeah.
Yeah.
So it's plus 4 for attack roll?
Plus 4.
Plus 1d4.
Oh, yeah,
plus 1d4.
Yeah, so when you roll 1d20 plus with your modifier plus 1d4 when you attack.
Okay.
However, these guys don't like Brunnar, and they're going to go on him. These guys roll for plus 3. They're tiny hand axes. One manages to hit, dealing 1d6 damage. He could take him out right now. He doesn't.
Oh, halfway. Oh, man.
So yeah, one of them managed to slip past your armor and they hit you in the back of the leg. Doran. With your twin hand axes. unfortunately, this one did see you and he would have hit you there.
I thought next didn't do...
Opportunity attacks?
When you're still within range of them?
No. I'm fairly certain we do. It's the same as before, as far as I know. Where if you move out of a space, that they can attack.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that, but we'll go by your rules. It's all good.
It's preferable anyway. If you want, you can change your attack then.
Yep. So, 10. Actually, I'll continue to do that, but I'll tumble instead to see if I get through it.
I will allow that. Sure. Beat this guy's thing with the acrobatics, mother effer. Plus 9. That's 4 plus 5. 3 plus 5. Ridiculous. Yeah, this guy would miss anyways.
And our drow friend is getting 2 axes. Just clarifying, the bless is an added 1d4 to attack?
1d4 to your attack, yes.
And
so,
saving throws.
And that's to each
damage,
attack.
Not damage.
Okay, I just want to make sure. That's,
so
that's
yeah, so roll, bonus. Roll your attacks and then add 1d20 to each. Oh, 1d4 to each.
It's included.
Is that included? Okay, so that's it. It's not including an extra 1d4.
Oh, hold on. I only added that to the second roll. I forgot to do it to the first one. So I'm just going to roll them individually and just add them to the first rolls.
Sure.
So that's a 26 and a 15.
Cool. They both hit.
All right. So
Attack is magical. So that would be 5, 6, 7, 8 damage.
Yeah, and he's adjacent to my ally, so sneak attack does apply.
Nice. So that's how much damage?
So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 altogether.
14 damage. Oh, okay, dear gosh. I was thinking, why does this guy have such low health? It's because he's undead and they have different health. Cool. So if you manage to start slicing at him, you start taking parts of him off. He's a little too quick for you. But you do manage to get like his shoulder blade chopped off and things like that. So you do believe you hurt him pretty good.
Take that, you shambling corpse, you!
Bruno!
Give me a sec. Using my second wind would give me nothing here. So I guess...
Yeah, it would give you 1d6 plus... One.
Yeah, it would.
Because it gives you. Yeah, it's not up to your maximum. It's artificial health, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, but in that case, receiving 3 attacks. Yeah. Maybe if I could do some damage to him.
True.
Yeah, but I would still die next round. Fuck.
Well, it's only if you get hit.
Screw it, I'm a fighter, I'm gonna kill him faster than he does.
Sounds good.
So it's basically plus d4.
Yeah, plus 1d4. It's gonna hit regardless, 22. It's a match. The max this guy would have is 18. He's not at 18.
So I only roll d4, straight to damage. This better be good. Shit.
Luckily, that's still slashing. Is still a lot of damage. You managed to chop his right arm right off.
Oh, that's one weapon less.
Yep. The redead. Boom, boom, boom. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you two are now officially surrounded. The redead from above is going to attack Brunner. He's gonna get plus 3, he's plus 2. Oh, he's not good though. But Doran is gonna hurt you really bad, I bet. Yep. Yeah, I figured. As this guy attacks you with whatever weapon he's holding, it's gonna be 1d4. He does 2 points of damage as he starts ripping at you.
No. Doesn't sound like a lot, but level 1, it still fucking hurts.
Well, sure, yeah. Does. And, ooh, look who's turned this Farron. With one good arm, he is going to try to stab at Doran, who he doesn't like. Gonna stab at Doran. 14.
15 AC.
Ooh, you're good. You're out. You're fine. He's not going to risk moving. Zangorn.
I'm going to come out from behind my pillar, and I am going to cast Sacred Flame on the drow bitch.
Beautiful.
So, I need to roll d20 plus...
1d4 for the bless.
1d4.
Beautiful.
I hit.
Almost a crit. Okay, give me some damage.
Hold on.
1d8.
Yeah, 1d8 radiant damage, so it's beautiful. Doubled.
What's doubled?
Well, it's undead, so doesn't radiant damage do double?
Maybe, I don't know. But you do see your bolt sear right through his stomach, and leave a large hole on the other side.
I hope you weren't hungry.
Yeah. You see him, he's lost his spine at this point, so he's kind of shambling around. He's having difficulty. These guys are going to try to attack Doran and Brunar, first with Brunar without advantage.
And now with Doran, with advantage. So 5 points of damage to Doran.
This uncanny knack of getting me to exactly one hit point.
Yeah, I love that. I love when it happens so much. It happened to me the other day. Felt so good. I won that battle. Doran, you're up.
Die, you putrescence pitch. Fuck.
Oh, wow. Two ones. Amazing.
Actually, wait.
That's right, you can't get a one. Beautiful.
Halfling, I can reroll that.
That's a lucky that you got a one, isn't it?
So, the 23 on the use of combat.
Sure, I guess we'll allow that. So 23, that means you hit and you deal 6 plus 4, meaning you,
Is there 5-foot steps in Pathfinder? In the next?
The 5-foot steps? There's disengage. And disengage, you basically use your whole action to try to move half your speed.
Okay.
You slice his head off. And as you do, his head falls to the ground. The crown rolls towards Zanward. Rolls towards Zanward, who kind of stops with his foot. And the zombies all here fall to the ground.
Doran looks around, sees the corpses, the new corpses fall to the ground. Raises an axe in hand and puts his foot on top of the drow's, what's left of their body, and just puts his other hand on his hip, heroically. Probably looking like a fool because he's such a 3-foot halfling.
Yeah. Alright, while he's doing that...
Fast forward to 20 years later where that's a portrait of you that hangs over your mantle.
While he's doing that, and in the background of the portrait is going to be me walking up and taking the crown.
Cool.
I really don't want Doran to have the crown. I don't entirely trust him. I'm going to manage the crown.
Cool. Not like the thing would fit on my head. It would be a necklace.
It's not
going
to fit on my head either.
And Brunar, during this, what do you do?
Search.
So the portrait contains Doran with his foot over it, Xanar behind him holding the crown triumphantly, and Brunar in the back looking for some treasure.
Yeah.
You actually do pull out a small chest. You kind of jam it open. And you find there's some silver in there. It's a small box of silver. And that'll be game, gentlemen. Yeah, you would take the crown back or keep it, and get all your money for it. And success.
I didn't die.
You didn't die, buddy. GG.
I tell you that.
I didn't take even 1 point of damage.